Start feeling better every day with Relief Factor, a daily supplement designed to support your body's fight against aches and pains.
Not only do I move better without pain, I just feel better.
Created by doctors, Relief Factor uses a unique formula of natural ingredients that target four metabolic pathways to address pain. Relief Factor doesn't just mask aches and pains, it helps reduce or even eliminate them.
Today, I do the things I love, and it doesn't occur to me to think about pain.
You can feel the difference all day, every day.
Join the over 1 million people who have tried Relief Factor's 3-week quick start kit. It's only $19.95. Visit relieffactor.com or call 1-800-4-RELIEF. That's 1-800, the number 4-RELIEF. And feel the difference of Relief Factor.
Ruff, ruff. Look out. That's an air. It's only me. It's only the camera. With Pete Davis, sidekick producer at Sports Raconteur Extraordinaire, and the mechanical mangler at the controls. You know him as Flounder. And look out, it's freaking Tuesday. I'll be talking about that bridge thing. Oh my God. I don't understand how it's possible that anybody was on that bridge. I mean, we'll talk about it. That's a thing. Also at 3:03 with the Kimmer Pete and Flounder. 10 years ago, I'd have taken a flamethrower to this place. Sorry, I just felt like saying that. I don't know why. I never got to use a flamethrower. I always wanted to use a flamethrower. I don't know. I guess I don't even know if they have any. When I was in the
Marines, you can rent one.
You can? Oh, man, yeah. Would I love to do that. Excuse me.
Let's get you a flamethrower.
I need a flamethrower for the Kimmer. How about a GoFundMe? Kimmer needs a flamethrower. Remember the time? I don't know what I was thinking. I did it for kicks, just as a... I sure remember. Back in the day, it wasn't that long ago, there was no such thing as GoFundMe. All of a sudden, people started saying, have this GoFundMe thing where you could raise money for a good cause or whatever. And I thought, gee, that was great. And then all of a sudden, people started really trying to take advantage of, I'm so sorry. So I actually put up a GoFundMe saying, I'm sick and tired of not really being able to afford to have a private country club membership. Now, I don't want to spend my own money for something like that because I have a family to support. So I'm really trying to, it's really not fair that I can't find someone to be able to, so I was asking for money to have me join a private country club because I didn't want to spend my own money. And someone actually sent me $50, I swear to God. I never joined. I don't know what happened to it. I never did anything about the account. But somewhere is a Kim Peterson GoFundMe account with $50 in it to go get me on a private golf course. Oh, my God. Idiot. Anyway, 3:05. Molly, Miss Molly, my little granddaughter. I love that little girl. That's just a special little girl. 10 years old today. And I put a video on my Facebook page and also YouTube of them having a little party last night, blowing out the candles and the balloons on fire and stuff. And so they'll be having a little stuff today. And so I just wanted to say happy birthday, Molly. She's 10 years old, and she's precious. You've never seen her. She's stunningly beautiful. She's got the Peterson blue eyes. Her hair gets blondish and blue and brownish. But she's just stunning. She's fearless. She's a jock. I mean, she's athletic, totally a daredevil. You've seen the videos I posted of her doing things that scare me just to watch her doing. She's also in a gifted school. She's sweet, kind. Everybody loves her. She'll always have friends. I mean, it's unbelievable. And, thanks to her, the genetics are due to the family tree, but her personality and her being such a sweet girl and a giving and kind and nurturing and, I mean, everything about her, there's not one bad thing. She's wonderful, and because of that Sarah and Dan, their family, just and Brady, your brother, I'm so happy and proud of them, I can't tell you. And that little Molly, I just love that little girl, 10 years old, riding horses, has a little pony, she leases a pony, and so anyway, happy birthday, Molly. Kimmer, Pete, and Flounder, here's the number, 404-741-1230, 741-1230. We'll have the latest on that bridge business. And again, I have a lot of questions. No, so far, my main question is, when did the power go out? Exactly what minute did the power go out? Why was that ship even anywhere near that bridge if it's not an expansion bridge that goes up and down? I mean, was it supposed to be going under that bridge? That bridge didn't, no one's explained whether that's a bridge, you know, that opens up, or was there room to go under it and he just couldn't aim because the power went out with the steering? I mean, I still don't know why it hit the bridge. I don't know why the ship was there. Obviously, it's a shipping channel, but if the ship lost control, at what minute did he lose control? How long would it take to call 911, let alone blow your horn or do anything else and get on the ship's horn and all this stuff? Aren't those bridges manned 24 hours a day with ship traffic going through there? You would think, like, Cal, when I lived in Florida, oh my God, when I was in Palm Beach County, Florida, there are bridges to everything. You can't go 5 miles without having to cross a bridge. And if there's an issue or a problem or a disaster, wham! I mean, those things open and shut down, and that's it. I mean, there's no goofing around. So I don't know what's going on with the Francis Scott Key Bridge. But the other thing is, how is it possible that anybody was on that bridge? Did you see the video of cars 10 seconds before the ship hit the thing? And I'm thinking, oh my God, can you imagine that guy's rear view mirror? The last one across, oh my lordy. But why were there construction workers filling potholes when that ship was about to hit? I mean, I don't. How long did it take to say, everybody off, close the bridge? It said, well, to get most of the traffic off the bridge. What do you mean most? Why did anybody get on that bridge when that ship lost control, period?
One thing, it was 1:30 in the morning, so I'm
but
sure.
But still, this is ship traffic. This is cargo ships 24 hours a day. They obviously have to man the damn thing. Maybe not. I mean, I would be flabbergasted if there's nobody manning the bridge over a major cargo traffic in Baltimore and going onto the ocean. I mean, but again, no one said, I don't know. I don't know. Anyway, I'm sorry. I mean to do the whole thing in this whole thing here. So we'll talk a lot about that, too. Also, Donald Trump. Those freaking idiot Democrats. The more they do, the more they stick it in their neck. How about up your butt? How about that? Donald Trump. Oh, by the way, he is so broke, and they're going to take all his properties. Yeah, he's now worth $6 billion. You idiots. I mean, everything they do makes him better. It's going to be a landslide. I mean, oh, my God. I mean, I got the stock. Oh, now he's worth $6 billion. Everything. You know, and by the way, if they had not blocked him from Facebook and social media, he never would have started Truth Social. This all would have been moot. There was no way. If they just left him alone and let him just, you know, be in his little angry self and just ignored him, they probably would have been a hell of a lot better off. But instead, they feel, oh, yeah, I'll show you. And he just showed him he's worth $6.5 billion. My God, I freaking love it. And by the way, even if that's little stock, even if that's people who just wanted to show support by buying one share of stock, I mean, you know, even so, say, I've heard somebody say, if he tried to sell, you know, 1 million shares, the stock price would plummet. I mean, because obviously it would be a whole thing. But still, the fact of the matter is people bought that stock for one reason or another, either to make money or just to show support. Either way, Donald Trump just made $6.4 billion. So suck it, Democrats. You really did it yourself, you freaking idiots. Anyway, Ronna McDaniel, there's a meeting at NBC and news executives right now, apparently, on what to do with her. This is so disgusting and disgraceful. The death of the First Amendment started under this administration. It started under Donald Trump when he came down that escalator. The death of the First Amendment, I mean, the communications in this country is an appalling disgrace. Since Donald Trump came down that freaking escalator, we'll talk about that too. And what they're going to do with Ronna McDaniel, And holy cow, the P. Diddy case. I'm not even sure what to think about this. They call him the black. Who's the dead? The strangled guy in the jail, Jeffrey Epstein. They called him the black Jeffrey Epstein. P. Diddy, holy crap, and that's all over social media. And also now, Cuba Gooding Jr. has been headed to one of the other lawsuits against P. Diddy for sexual assault of a guy. Oh, I mean, you know,
how many
know.
Times are we going to hear about Cuba and guys?
I don't, the whole thing makes me ill. We will talk about Ron DeSantis stopping kids under 14 from getting on social media. What do you think? That's going to be a lawsuit about that. You know, a whole bunch of stuff like that. Also, Flounder, if you remind me, and Pete, let's do it. Look at the tickets. We have tickets to the, Well, now I can't find it. To that show, that not a movie, not a king, not a prime minister. Where the
hell Kill a Mockingbird.
To Kill a Mockingbird. And I don't even have, here it is. No, I've got the Nuckies thing.
Where is that a new movie or something?
Now, Flounder, you gave it to me, and I don't have it. Here it is. No, I don't have that. I got the hourly reads. Anyway, Kill a Mockingbird, we have tickets to give away, and I'll find them. We'll do it in the 4 o'clock hour. Where the hell did I put? I swear to God you gave it to me, didn't you? Did you give me that a thing on the I have the hourly sponsor, and I have the Nuckies Hoagies on Friday, and I don't have a ticket thing. So we'll take care of it. Flounder's going to get that for us right now, and we'll do it at 4 o'clock. We'll give away the tickets to Kill a Mockingbird at the Fox Theater. And it's on Friday. I forgot what date, but it's on a Friday and in a couple of weeks, I think. Or no, maybe in May. I don't remember. We'll figure it out.
It's going from May 7th to the 12th.
Aha. There you are. Sorry, man. All right, 313. Oh, God. I don't know. I'm already exhausted. And how's that weather out there? Yeah, boy. Jeez, I hope that stopped now. Good grief. Anyway. And The Bachelor, and Fixin' I 20, and Shogun, and Pete's Got a Game, and Flounder's Funnies, and all that stuff. We got a million things coming up with the Kipper, Pete, and Flounder on 106.3. Look out.
Get on up. Look, I tap the feeling. Get on up. Sure as your bone. Get on up. Get it together. Right on, right on. Right on, right on.
The legend Neil Bortz is only on Extra 106.3. Hey, it's the camera. How's it going? Here's what you missed from the Talkmaster.
Since the 1952 presidential election, Democrats, for instance, have told us the Republicans want to take away your Social Security. And they're telling us that now. Because the idea of having retirement money snatched away from you just as you're finishing your work life is one of the most frightening things you can imagine.
Catch Neil's commentary every day on Extra 106.3 or listen anytime on the Extra 106.3 app.
Neil Bortz here. Maybe you've already taken the steps to improve your health, maybe save your life. You're using a CPAP for your sleep apnea. I've been using one for well over 20 years. So right now, I'm here to tell you about a source for CPAPs and CPAP supplies here in the Atlanta area. CPAPs, etc. They're in Alpharetta. They have whatever you need. Roddy and Sharon are your CPAP experts, and they'll ship nationwide. More information, CPAPs, ET. PC.com.
5 stars all rise for To Kill a Mockingbird. Unmissable and unforgettable. A mockingbird for our moment. Beautiful, elegiac, satisfying, even exhilarating. A New York Times critic's pick. Mockingbird is now the most successful American play in Broadway history. All rise for Aaron Sorkin's great play. Richard Thomas is Atticus Finch in Harper Lee's To Kill a Mockingbird.
Playing at the Fox Theater May 7th through the 12th. For tickets, visit BroadwayInAtlanta.com.
Hey, Atlanta. It's Ben, host of the Weekend Ben Burnett Show, proudly brought to you by Peach State Pride. Each and every weekend, we bring you all the issues going on around the globe and what America's ultimate role is in order to drive our agenda forward as conservatives. And if you ever miss an episode, you can download everything I've ever done on Apple, Spotify, or you can go to the podcast park. See you around, Atlanta.
You shouldn't need a degree in finance to choose a checking account. That's why we made Truist One Checking. No trade-offs, no compromise, no hassle. Just the stuff you want from a bank that cares. And that means no overdraft fees, lots of practical perks, and automatic upgrades. Truist One Checking. One simple choice.
Monthly, where you'll find familiar faces, local voices, and community businesses like JRM Management.
Thanks, Tara. I'm Missy Miller, event coordinator at JRM Management. We are your event specialist. We are excited to see you at the Georgia Food and Wine Festival, March 21st through the 24th. We'll have food, beverages, cooking demos, live music, shopping, and more. Or maybe you're looking for an event where you can bring the entire family. Join us at the Marietta Community Egg Hunt Friday, March 29th, and the Northeast Cobb Community Egg Drop Saturday, March 30th. There will be multiple egg hunts by age and lots of kid-friendly activities. Also, look out for the Kennesaw Big Shanty Festival, the Smyrna Spring Jonquil Festival, and of course, the North Georgia State Fair. There's always something fun happening in our community, and we want you to know about it. That's why we love our partnership with Our Town Monthly.
You are so right, Missy. If JRM is there, the fun follows. Friends, check out all the exciting community events hosted by JRM Management. And remember, Our Town is your town at Our Town Monthly.
I just had a very weird memory about a piano man and a girl who tried to get me to do something I didn't want to do. Kind of a weird story with a Kimmer and Pete and Flounder to Tuesday. I used to love this song. I can put myself right there thinking, man, you're sitting there and you're playing these melancholy tunes and wondering what your life's going to be, and people are sitting there drinking and wondering what happened, and they're cheating on their wife, all together, the whole aura of the, you know, the darkened bar and the piano player and so forth, and it's kind of sad and iconic and a pretty song, though. Billy Joel, what a talent. Play me a memory. Billy Joel, 2016, The Piano Man. When I wore a younger man's clothes. Billy Joel's hit Piano Man. This is another thing I'm kind of surprised. Rolling Stone's list of the 500 greatest songs of all time. Of the 500 greatest, this song was only 421. Huh, I thought there you are. I guess I, as you know, I know nothing about music. You keep telling me, and you're right every time. I mean, I don't care either, 35319. Birthdays, Miss Molly, my granddaughter, 10 years old. What a little, just a treasure. She's just a little treasure, and I wish I could spend more time with my family. Sorry.
You got a week off next week. What are you going to do?
Well, I'm going to see my family.
Okay, then. Shut the blank up.
All right, fine. Well, I don't get to see all of them because they're all over, you know, but I'm going to see some of them. Anyway, and my favorite ex-wife and her husband, and it'll be fun, and Jennifer, anyway. And by the way, I had to ask Jennifer about a thing I'm going to take with me to give away Friday when we do our show. I talk about that. Anyway, birthday list, Keira Knightley, 39 years old. She was in Pirates of the Caribbean, Bend It Like Beckham, Pride and Prejudice, Love Actually. And she was in, what was that movie with that guy that everybody, a girl's loving me, I can't remember his name. And he was, he worked for Kevin Costner, was with the CIA, and the star of the show was not supposed to be, he was supposed to be an analyst, a banker analyst over in Europe for the Russians. And then his wife.
That's a good,
good movie.
Amber Heard was in it too.
That was a good movie. I can't remember that. It was Kevin Costner played his boy, and he said, well, you're an agent now. And the guy had to be a big time Charlie's undercover CIA guy.
Well, no,
and Keira Knightley was his girlfriend who showed up out of nowhere to be with him in a hotel. Wasn't that it?
Okay, this is two different movies. And there's one where Kevin Costner's in Europe where he is the actual operative. And there's one where he takes the original Chris Pine.
Chris Pine, that was it. Yeah, that was it.
That was one of the Jack.
Jack.
Not Jack.
I know. You're right. Yeah. That was one I'm thinking. That was Keira Knightley.
The movies with Harrison Ford that he did a couple.
Jack
on
Ryan. That one was Jack Ryan. Shadow Recruit.
Look at Flounder. Look at you in there.
That would be
coming
the work
up
of Google.
A Googling of looking with Googleness. Oh, God. By the way, for the record, freaking Google starting to pop up more freaking pop-up ads all of a sudden. Have you noticed
that? That's why you got to go to DuckDuckGo.
The problem is I go to DuckDuckGo, but by habit, just because, you know, I've been doing it for 10 years or whatever it is, I go to Google first because it is quicker on one thing of my history. When I look up the people's history, the Google looking that up is real quick, and I get there fast. DuckDuckGo is harder to find that one, but out of habit. And Google's doing a lot of these freaking pop-ups. It's freaking making me very upset. And by the way, so is Fox News's news app. All of a sudden, every time on the lead story, boom, all of a sudden it's freaking commercial. You got to wait 15 seconds to get rid of it or something.
One of the issues I have with Fox is if I'm on a different computer or one that I'm not signed up on, if I go to the story, if I hit the link, it'll make me enter a email address, and then I have to go to that email and verify it.
Okay, I'm going to say something now that'll make your day.
Okay.
They're going to make a sequel to The Accountant.
Oh, my God. That was a great movie.
Mm-hmm.
Even though that girl was the wrong girl for the part, I liked her. She was okay in it. The little skinny
one,
the singer.
She's not in this one.
I can't remember her name. The little skinny girl. Who it was in a singing movie with some kids one time.
Anyway,
whatever. Is it going to be still the same guy? He was great in that role, man.
Yeah, Ben Affleck.
Yeah.
And John Bernthal, his brother, is coming back.
Yeah. Oh, man, that was a great movie. I still have it on my DVR. That's one of the ones I've saved.
Filmed here. Filmed around Lake Lanier.
Yep, that's right. I have that one. I have the Denzel Washington, two of the Denzel Washington ones where he plays the former spy guy. The Equalizer and the other, and Equalizer 2.
The third one's not that good.
I don't think I've seen the third one. Anyway, sorry, I got distracted. 323. That was her birthday. Was Keira Knightley, 39. I think I said, did I say 39? Hold on, I just wrote over it. 39. And on this day in history, heavens to Murgatroyd, 1997 even. 39 members of a cult named Heavens, not to Murgatroyd, but Heaven's Gate. These idiots were found dead, I tell you, dead, in Rancho Santa Fe, California, in a mansion. They were convinced that if they overdosed on a mixture of phenobarbital and vodka, they would die happy and their souls would be welcomed aboard a secret spaceship hidden behind the Hale-Bopp comet. Marshall Applewhite and Bonnie Nettles were the good talkers in the group to tell them, yeah, drink this and we're all going to get to ride the comet. And they were all wearing Nike sneakers. Remember the whole thing about the fell? Oh, God. I mean, Lord, Mike.
I used to watch that comet in the middle of the afternoon at my apartment in Virginia Highlands, overlooked the Highlands, and you could see that sucker bright as a damn cloud up there.
It's a 324, Kim, repeat, and flounder, 404-741-1230, 741-1230. Our 3 o'clock hour brought to you by our friends at First Liberty Building and Lawn. If you need, I didn't mean to yell at you. I was just trying to encourage you to be out. If you need financing to grow your business, visit firstlibertyga.com. There you are. Let's see, 324, Kim, repeat, and flounder again. Now, somebody called in to talk to Flounder and said they thought it was this thing was a drawbridge, the Francis Scott Key. I don't think it's a drawbridge. It didn't look like a drawbridge.
I don't think it was a drawbridge for the reason. That's why you were. It was over 185 feet.
Yeah, there's no way that's
it is
a
now.
Well, yeah, it's a no bridge now.
They bring it down.
It's a new reef for the fish, is what it is now. No, but seriously, I mean, I can't believe. We need to know how long it was between the ship's captain saying, I can't steer, to the time it hit the bridge. Those ships, even when they're stopped, they're not going 30 miles an hour. They're going 4 knots, maybe, which is, you know, walking speed. So how I don't understand why the video still shows cars driving across the bridge, including one who was there like 6 seconds before it hit. I can't
Rusty's
imagine what he saw in his rearview mirror.
Rusty's in the club.
And can you imagine the noise? The noise of that steel birch collapsing. Oh my God. It must have scared the crazy. I mean, I can't imagine.
And all those lights of the fire trucks and the police lights, and you see them just go into the drink.
I don't know. I don't get it. We need to know how long it was. That means everything. And by the way, how is President Pukeface the murderer suddenly saying, well, we're going to pay for it all? Whoa, hold on a second. Sounds to me like the ship's responsibility for ramming the bridge is the ship's responsibility. That's just off the top of my head. I don't want to be a lawyer or anything. I'm just saying, let's see, the ship lost power. That was their fault. Okay, unless Donald Trump. I bet the FBI is investigating Mar-a-Lago now to see whether Donald Trump had something to do with it. But he sent his undercover spy agencies up to ruin the bridge to try to blame it on Democrats in Baltimore with all their crime or something, I'll bet you. The FBI is going to arrest Donald Trump for that, probably, I'll bet you. Unbelievable. I mean, the freaking company, the cargo group company's at fault.
You want to hear a funny story? When we were kids, Dad took us down the Chesapeake, where you go, that underwater tunnel that goes to Virginia from Maryland.
I've never been it, but I've heard of it, yeah.
Well, my mom says, I don't want to do it because a ship could hit it. Well, it's under. And my dad, being an engineer, gave this big speech, the whole thing about it's impossible for a ship to hit it. They buried it far too deep, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. We're not home 2 weeks before a ship plowed into it and flooded it. She did not let him forget that one.
I'll bet that's true. By the way, it occurred to me, it would seem to me that that an ocean liner or a huge cargo ship, and again, these things can't stop. If the engines die, they're still moving at whatever the momentum is. They can't stop. It takes like a mile to stop a ship. So it would seem to me that if these, maybe, I guess it's cost prohibitive, it would seem to me fairly easy to have some giant sliding steel panels in the sides of the ship, hidden inside the hull of the ship. And if you come to an emergency where the engine's going and you're going to hit the land or something, you drop those shields down in the water and it'll stop the ship.
What about an anchor?
Well, an anchor, it depends how deep the water is. If the water's 1,000 feet deep, you're going to have to hell of an anchor on a chain. No, well, I mean, I'm just saying, if you're in the ocean, I mean, it's not, you know, we've come in, it depends how deep it is. If you don't have an anchor that would be that big and drag along on the bottom. But if you had steel plates on either side of the ship and just drop them in the water, there's no way that the ship could move with those big plates blocking the momentum of the current.
Quit telling everybody this. You should go patent it right now.
Well, it's kind of like Kramer says, you know, you can put the oil tanker should have a big rubber balloon inside the tanker, so in case the ship wrecks, they still got the balloon to take care of it. Oh, yeah, oh, hell. And I, by the way, it was my idea to have a cologne for men smells like the beach.
How many bridges are you going to come across in the ocean, by the way?
I don't know. I was just saying. If it was an emergency, it was just an idea.
I see a slight flaw.
Shut up.
A slight flaw.
you could have panels coming down to save the people. And stopping the boat from hitting the people. Yeah, mock me. Mock me. It could be a life-saving idea from the Kimmer show right here. Kimmer, Pete, and Flounder. I'm not even going to include it. I'm Kimmer and Flounder. It's the time for a break yet. Oh, shut up. Yeah, eat me. How about that? Coming up. By the way, I'm getting a lot of comments. I put a Facebook thing on stuff I'm going to give away on our little Friday outing at Nucky's Hoagies, including... it's actually a momentous memento of the end of the worst year of my life. And I think I'll give it away on Friday. Anyway, it's weird. Coming up at 3:30, Kimmer, Pete, and Flounder. It's only Tuesday. It's only Tuesday? Oh, geez. Oh, my God.
The Kimmer Show is only on Extra 106.3 every weekday afternoon on your drive home.
When you hear Jamie Raskin and Chuck Schumer and Morning Joe saying, boy, President Pukeface is as good as he's ever been, the best Biden ever, and claiming that Trump's a Nazi and all this stuff, they know that that's not true. The bottom line is, it's hard to really believe that they want you to be deceived about the nature of your own country.
The Kimmer Show, every afternoon from 3 to 6 p.m. on Extra 106.3 and the Extra app.
You know, that really is the thing that bothers me the most. When these people say things like that, they're lying. They don't really believe it. They're doing it on purpose to destroy our what we stand for. Anyway, I've got to do my things here. You know, the 4 o'clock hour, sponsored by our good friends at Atlanta Safe House, and by golly, I'm going to sponsor them right now. I love these folks. Speaking of, you know, the anti-woke thing, honest to Pete, you know, lock them up. Lock up the whole freaking bunch of those. I'll bet you the Atlanta Safe House, I'll bet you Jeff and Mark could build a freaking safe. You know, they can actually build you a family storm shelter. I wonder if you guys, I'm going to call them later, see if you guys can build a great big storm shelter to lock up all these stinking lying Democrats trying to ruin our country. Sorry, that's another part of the commercial. It's just part of my thing here. Anyway, Jeff and Mark, you got to love these guys. Non-woke company, when they send somebody to deliver the safe to where you want it, your home or business or wherever, they can bolt it from the inside in your garage or in the concrete floor, your basement, or anything you want. They only use off-duty police and firefighters and military to do it and say thank you for what you do. Great folks and great products. Check out their pistol safes. A lot of folks don't think about that. Instead of just putting it in the glove compartment while you're doing something or whatever, pistol safes, another extra step. Also, obviously, for the house or office and that kind of thing. Jewelry safes, business safes, high security safes. I have bought 2 gun safes and they're always on sale. Great prices. The great types of Browning and Fort Knox and American Security, the best brands there are. And they also the professional delivery and installation service number 1 in Georgia. And, you know, keep your stuff. I lost my medical records in Florida because I didn't have my safe down there. Now the VA saying, don't bother us anymore. You can't prove what we know you did. Anyway, whatever. It's my fault. Don't be like the Kimmer. Be better than the Kimmer. That's fairly easy, by the way. Lock your stuff up. Tell them the Kimmer sent you. When you check them out, they have a showroom in Ackworth and on the web, atlantasafehouse.com.
Is the tax deadline causing you anxiety? Searching for elusive 1099s and trying to uncover any exemptions? If so, you're not alone. Every year, Georgians find themselves looking backwards to file with the IRS, reporting tax history. But what if you were to flip the script? Not just report your taxes, but actually planning for them. We're Master Plan Retirement Consultants. We're local, with offices in Marietta. We work with folks just like you to create a personalized, tax-efficient strategy designed to last a lifetime, a crucial piece to the holistic retirement plan. Do you have a retirement roadmap? You should. It's never too late. Visit MasterPlanRetire.com. Don't wait any longer. Visit MasterPlanRetire.com.
Advisory services offered through Master Plan Retirement Consultants, Inc., a registered investment advisory in the state of Georgia. Insurance, tax, and commodity services offered through Frickson Associates, Inc., DBA Master Plan Retirement Consultants. The aforementioned are affiliated companies.
Millions of guys suffer from erectile dysfunction.
That's one in four men. And I can tell you, I'm one of them.
If you or someone you know suffer from ED, Peyronie's disease, or PE, here's 38-year emergency room doctor and founder of Total Body Therapy of Georgia, Dr. Eric Deal.
Patients who enter my office are often frustrated, hopeless, depressed, and embarrassed. I understand the problem, and I'm going to help you fix it. There are lots of competitors that don't have the credentials that I have. When you go to other clinics, you're not going to see board-certified physicians with the experience that I have. When you come to our clinic, you're going to see me. There's just not one therapy that can solve these complex issues. I'll do a complete history and physical prior to any treatment that we use. Take it from me, Dr. Deal. When it's not hard, it's really hard.
Call Dr. Deal for your free one-on-one evaluation and resolve your ED, Peyronie's, or PE issues. Total Body Therapy of Georgia, 404-777-1911. 404-777-1911. Online at StopMyED.com.
Central Heating and Air Conditioning wants you to know the start of the new season is the perfect time to ensure your home's comfort. Don't wait like most people do to have your HVAC system serviced. Your home should have maintenance twice a year. Maintenance helps keep your system running at peak efficiency and extends the life of your equipment. So turn to Atlanta's Carrier experts for your system's maintenance. With Central, you get Carrier products, Carrier warranty, and Carrier peace of mind. It's allergy season, and Central Heating and Air can fix what ails your house and possibly your family with home ventilation and air quality products. Central has packages designed around health using variable speed, fresh air ventilation, air cleaners, air purifiers, dehumidifiers, and more. Central Heating and Air is one of the few second-generation, locally owned and operated HVAC companies in Atlanta. With Central, you're not just a number, you're a member of the family. It's been that way since 1947, and they've serviced over 100,000 customers right here in Atlanta. Call 770-GET-HEAT or go to centralheat.com.
We're smart, we care, we're Central Heating and Air.
Lee Brand Jewelry and Watch Company, where quality and value make the difference. Locally owned and located in Sandy Springs, offering you the finest selection of unique diamonds, sapphires, rubies, and emerald jewelry, as well as other fine gemstones. Lee Brand Jewelry and Watches has been servicing Rolex watches for over 30 years, and their Rolex-trained watchmaker will service your watch in their state-of-the-art Rolex service center in their store. Lee Brand uses only genuine Rolex parts, and their estimates are free. Drop by Lee Brand in the Trader Joe's Shopping Center in Sandy Springs or visit LeeBrand.com.
Oh, my God. Oh, boy. Are you playing this backwards? Is this like an LP and you're playing it backwards? I swear to God. What the? I mean, I honestly, this
is horrible.
It's just
that bad.
Oh, my God. This is freaking horrible. This is like noise. This is an accident. Oh, God. 336. Well, it's the Diddy. It's the Diddy. It's the Diddy. Yeah, on this day, we got a lot of Diddy news here today. 2008, on this day, the LA Times apologized for claiming that rap mogul Diddy Combs was involved in the 94 shooting of Tupac Shakur. The Times published the original story on its website, said its claims were based on FBI records, witness accounts, and other unnamed sources. The apology followed a claim the newspaper was conned by a prisoner who doctored the documents. Now, coming up, we'll be talking about P. Diddy and his good buddy, what's his name? Cuba Gooding Jr. By the way, it's Cuba, not Cuba. Right? It's Cuba, I believe. But first, we have to keep our format proper here with the Kemmer, Pete, and Flounder, 337 404-741 1230 1230. Our birthday list includes Michael Imperioli, 58, Tony's unibrowed nephew on The Sopranos. Not a happy ending for old Michael. What's that?
Christopher.
She's a hua. She's just a hua. Carmella. Anyway, what a great series. It was a terrible ending in a great series, and I know I'm the only one who says that. Let's see. History. I got a history thing here somewhere, and I can't find. Here we go. Oh, no, that's not it. Let me see that one for later. Here we go. I think we just talked about this in a tangential way recently. 1999, Dr. Jack Kevorkian murders a 52-year-old man, Thomas Yoke, on 60 Minutes. Well, it was a tape of him euthanizing the man with the final stage of ALS. Kevorkian was convicted of second-degree murder, sentenced to 10 to 25 years. He got out in 8 on the condition that he would stop killing people. And so he still was an advocate for it. I think he died. 338, Kemmer, Pete, and Flounder. Okay, now the P. Diddy thing. This is really wild boy poom-wa. And by the way, 50 Cent is now kind of taunting P. Diddy on Instagram as the people are reacting around the world, I guess, especially to the entertainment industry, about the news that Sean Diddy Combs' homes were raided by federal agents. The video of Diddy's houses in Los Angeles and Miami surrounded by Homeland Security agents. Let's see, 50 Cent shouted out, S blank just got real. The singer wrote in his caption, he said the people handcuffed by officers were Diddy's children. The feds and all the cribs, damn, they got the kids in cuffs. 50 Cent wrote, now it's not Diddy do it, it's Diddy done. That's cold, man.
It's brings not up the musical question.
Yeah.
Diddy do.
That's a very good question. It's Diddy done. They don't come like that unless they got a case, he says. One of the family of former members, Audrey O'Day, took to Instagram, a headline with a caption, what you sow, you shall reap. I pray this emboldens all of the U.S. victims to finally speak on what we have endured. This girl says she experienced everything from racial remarks to sexism. A lot of it was scary. In November 2023, a girl named Cassandra Ventura accused Diddy Combs of rape and repeated physical abuse. The lawsuits he allegedly controlled and abused her for more than 10 years, plied her with drugs, beat her, forced her to have sex with multiple male prostitutes while he watched and recorded it. She and he met in 2005. She was 19. She said before the end of their relationship in 2018, he forced his way into her home and raped her. He has denied it. At the stuff yesterday with the going into the homes, a police line was set up at the L.A. mansion. Two men were put in handcuffs. It's all related to an ongoing sex trafficking investigation. Homeland Security, agents on East and West Coast, law enforcement agents carrying bags and boxes of evidence to a van. The rapper and music mogul been fighting various legal battles, one against an unnamed woman claimed he and friends sexually assaulted her when she was 17. Rolling Stone says four Jane Does and one John Doe have already been interviewed by the U.S. attorney for the Southern District of New York. By the way, that's Southern District of New York is the vicious U.S. attorney's district in America, known for its unrelenting attacks. Sex trafficking, domestic violence, racketeering, according to the series of probes. A bunch of women have filed lawsuits against P. Diddy claiming sexual assault. And 50 Cent's been taking shots at him on social media, during his shows. Anyway, I got stuff like that. And one more quick update. A guy known as Rodney Jones, professionally known as Lil Rod, has now added Cuba Gooding Jr. to his complaint against Sean P. Diddy Combs, sexually harassing and assaulting him. In the new version of the suit obtained by Fox lawyers, he claimed Gooding, Cuba Gooding was touching and groping and fondling him at a party in a yacht rented by P. Diddy in the Virgin Islands last year. He rejected his advances. Cuba Gooding did not stop until Mr. Jones forcibly pushed him away. Cuba Gooding's been accused of sexual assault in the past. He was set to appear in court over accusations of rape last year, but he reached an agreement with the unidentified accuser before the trial was set to begin.
Seems he wants to see something more than just the money.
Show me that money. You can call it money if you want.
show me that.
On the money, all right. Holy smokes. 342, Kira, Pete, and Flounder. We got Flounder's Funnies coming up. Pete's got a game for it. You want to do a game?
Yeah.
You want to do it now?
Yeah, let's do it now.
Oh, let's do a game now. And then we have Pete's Tweets. We have Flounder's Funnies. We have Holy Crap at Sports. Oh, by Holy Crap at Sports, we got a Pete Rose connection. And, man, talk about a comment that may be hitting right on. And we'll talk about that. And I don't know what the latest is on this Shohei. But it's going to be
Shohei
ugly.
Ohtani.
Yeah, it's going to get ugly.
The ugly American.
Anyway,
there.
Pete
okay,
Diggs, right
get you a pen and paper right, ready.
Right,
ready?
I'm ready right
We're
now.
Going to find out what world travelers you two are.
World travelers, the two of us are. All right, sir.
Well, not just world travel, but here in the United States.
In the United States.
Okay?
All right, sir.
So give yourself a check if you've been to this place.
Okay.
All right. Flounder, you too.
All right. Here we go.
Alcatraz.
All right. Yep.
Arlington Cemetery.
Have not been to Arlington.
All right. I've seen Alcatraz, but I've never wanted to go there. It just doesn't.
Oh, it's unbelievable. You ought to do it. And go into solitary. Honest to God, go into solitary, and they turn off the lights, and you will freak. You'll be 8 seconds, and you'll go, get me out of here, get me out of here.
All right. Central Park.
I've been to parts of Central Park.
Yep.
The Chicago River.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep, yep.
Absolutely.
Empire State Building.
Yes.
Yep.
In fact, my brother and I went trip to New York, and I shouldn't have been here in the first place. I skipped school, took a bus, and we got there, and we asked a taxi to take us to the Empire State Building. We were a block away, and he drove us around for like 45 minutes. We were at the bus station. And, idiots.
You walk around with your heads. Yeah,
we didn't know
what
we were. We didn't know. They were all buildings. They were all big buildings. I didn't know which one.
Look at all these big buildings.
All right. The Everglades.
I have stood
in the Everglades.
I have not stood in
the airboat. And you get to go stand, and then he starts telling you about the pythons fighting the alligators while you're standing out there.
Yeah, not good. I've driven kind of in the area in a car. I've never actually been. Does that count?
You've got to do the airboat.
Yeah, I've never done the airboat. I'll put a note for
a lot of fun.
Yeah, I'll bet you.
All right. Fort Sumter.
No.
God, I have. I did go
there. Oh, wait. Yes, I have been. Yes.
There.
Yeah? Oh, I have not been there. All right. Of course, the French Quarter.
Oh, yes. Well, oh, yeah.
Yes,
oh,
yes.
Oh, it reminds me of The Bachelor on TV last night.
Keep moving.
Oh, sorry.
The Gateway Arch in St. Louis.
St. Louis, yeah.
I've been there. I refused to get in it.
I didn't go in it. I drove, you know, by.
We walked up. Jeff Hellinger walked up once and just looked at
it. We don't want to go in.
We're not going to get in it.
No.
Let's see. The Golden Gate Bridge.
I was there for the 50th anniversary. I walked across the Golden Gate Bridge for the 50th anniversary with about 50,000 people. On the 50th anniversary of the Golden Gate Bridge.
This game is going to take up the rest of the show.
I wanted to just, you know, pass. It's a bucket list. How many people get to do a 50th anniversary of the Golden Gate Bridge? And I walked it the whole way. No cars allowed on that day.
Amazing.
Thank you.
Amazing story.
Grand
Canyon.
Yes.
No, I have not been to the Grand Canyon.
Top and the bottom.
You have got to see it. I lived in Arizona.
Before.
I was in Phoenixville for 2 years.
It's one of the few places that you hear about your entire life, and when you go there, you're actually astounded that it's better than you thought.
I felt that way about Mount Rushmore.
Okay,
when I saw that.
We're getting there.
Okay.
We're getting there.
Right.
Hollywood sign. I have driven up to Hollywood sign.
You can't actually get there unless you have to sneak down the hill. I mean, they make it impossible to go get there anymore. Anyway, sorry.
It's close. Lake Tahoe.
Oh, yes. In fact, I think that's still the deepest lake in America, if I'm not mistaken.
All right, we're going to have to take a break now, so.
Okay.
We're running halfway through because of Captain Anecdote.
Yeah, but you can't, you know what a tease. You can't get this kind of entertainment anywhere else. They're all going to be keeping tune right through the break. This is the way it ought to be with American radio, people. The Kimmer, Pete, and Flounder, the old days. It's radio. It's radio again. Oh, my God. Oh.
Atlanta radio legends collide on Extra 106.3. The legend Neil Bortz is live every week with Atlanta legend The Kimmer. Because when you get these two guys together, who knows where we'll end up?
I am shocked. Shocked. Well, not that shocked.
The Kimmer is live on your drive home every weekday afternoon from 3 to 6. And now Neil Bortz joins the show every week. And if you miss it, catch up anytime on the Extra 106.3 app.
The Braves are back for the 2024 season and ready to fight for their seventh consecutive division title. Don't miss the opening homestand against the Arizona Diamondbacks April 5th through the 7th, followed by the New York Mets April 8th through the 11th. And on April 8th, the Braves will honor the 50th anniversary of Hank Aaron's record-breaking 715th home run with a special Hank Aaron bobblehead giveaway together with Truist. Visit Braves.com/promos to get your tickets today. Atlanta Braves baseball. We are Braves country.
This is Dan Watkins with All Four Seasons. We've always been Atlanta's best at installing and servicing garage and entry doors, but you would be surprised at how many windows we've installed as well. So we're proud to announce a new division, All Four Seasons Windows. We now have the ability to make sure every opening in your house is safe, energy efficient, and looks darn good. So give us a call today to schedule your free sales consultation. Find out how you can decrease your energy bills and increase the beauty and value of your home with All Four Seasons Garage, Entry Doors, and Windows.
Hey, sandwich lovers. Today's your lucky day. There's a whole new way to roll for lunch or dinner delight with Nucky's Hoagies in the Roswell Corners Shopping Center. Now open. Nucky's Hoagies in Roswell is family owned and operated by the sub-sisters, Stacy and Shannon, whose love language is food and Nucky's Hoagies, their passion. When you bite into a Nucky's Hoagie, you'll taste the difference. The softest hoagie rolls ever, along with hunger-quenching sandwich combinations. Make Nucky's Hoagies in Roswell on Woodstock Road your new favorite spot for lunch or dinner.
Hey there, it's Janelle King, host of the Janelle King Show right here on Extra 106.3 FM, where we are unafraid and unapologetic. We explore the topics that matter the most. You can catch us on Saturdays at 4 p.m. and encore episode on Sundays at 9 a.m. And catch up on past episodes by going to the podcast park right here at Extra 106.3 or wherever you get your podcasts every single Tuesday. Until then, stay unafraid, stay unapologetic, and never stop seeking the truth.
At the Piedmont Bank, we're proud to be one of Georgia's largest community banks, focusing on serving businesses and the communities they serve. With headquarters right here in Metro Atlanta, our tailored banking expertise and solutions help meet the diverse needs of our customers so they have what it takes to grow, expand, and thrive. It's what elevates us above the rest. Find a location near you at Piedmont.bank and experience elevated banking for you and your business. The Piedmont Bank. Banking elevated. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
We're going to get back to our contest in just a moment. Try to be patient. I know how much this means to you. And we're coming right back with a 350. Cameron Pete and Flounder. And this, the Zepperoni here. Readers on this day in 2006, readers of Total Guitar Magazine voted the guitar solo by Jimmy Page in Led Zeppelin's Stairway to Heaven as the greatest guitar solo of all time in 2006. The 1971 track was voted ahead of tracks by Van Halen, Queen, Jimi Hendrix, and the Eagles. And again, this was on 2006. On the 20th anniversary of the original release of the song, it was announced on U.S. radio sources the song had logged up an estimated 2.8 million radio plays back to back. That would be a solid 44 years without stopping.
First of all, that Eagles Hotel California riff does not belong there.
No,
Freebird from Lynyrd Skynyrd, especially the live version, is one of the top two guitar solos of all time. I'm sorry.
Okay. Well, maybe we maybe Flounder will find that for us later, and we'll
the end of Freebird when their guitars are in sync and they're going at it, unbelievable.
Okay. I remember that Flounder might find that for us if he has a chance later on, if he feels like it. If not, I'm throwing it out.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
We're going to go back to our test. Hold on, we're not done with that yet. We're just trying to entertain you. And the latest on the bridge collapse in Baltimore again. I don't get it. They're not telling us everything. I don't get it. First, birthday. Leslie Mann is 52. You may not know the name. It's a girl, Leslie. Leslie Mann, 52. Married to Judd Apatow, the idiot leftist. So she gets to be in all of his movies. You may know her as the drunk woman in The 40-Year-Old Virgin. I got the one driving and cracking up and stuff. Catherine Heigl's sister in Knocked Up. And the follow-up spinoff, This Is 40. Leslie Mann, 52 today. And I know that thing over there with the thing there over in the area. And our history list today, at 1804, Congress ordered the removal of all the Indians east of the Mississippi into Louisiana. And at the same time, the Louisiana Purchase was divided into the District of Louisiana and the territory of Orleans in 1804. And there go the Indians. 353, Kevin, Pete, and Flounder. And we'll talk more about the Trump. Oh, by the way, wait to hear what a Virginia county is doing to add something to Easter celebration this year. Coming up in a second. First, Pete Davis, back to our quiz of where we've been and where we have not.
By the way, I can't find the dark chocolate bunnies this year. It's all just milk chocolate and caramel and all that crap. Where's the dark chocolate bunnies?
Well, I'll look at when I go to my Publix run tomorrow to get the carrots ready for the weekend.
And by the way, they just pulled a body out of the water there up in Baltimore, so they found somebody, found one of the people.
I still don't get why anybody was on that bridge. There must have been time to say, get the hell off the bridge. Block the bridge. I don't get it. They got to be operating 24 hours a day. There are boats going under there. And
It's Baltimore.
Yeah, I mean, freaking Democrats, man. Probably a budget cutback. What do you bet? I bet they had a budget and they said, well, we can't afford to have a guy looking at that little tower. I mean, it's outrageous. A major shipping channel to the ocean. Jesus. Anyway, what do you got there? Contest.
Las Vegas Strip. You ever been there?
Oh, God.
Yes. Oh, God.
Vegas.
All
right. I have many stories about. Oh, sorry.
Maybe next week. Maybe that's where I'll end up.
Don't take your Porsche there. Don't drive.
Porsche?
Well, that either.
Yeah, I'm going to drive 2,300 miles to go to Vegas when I can fly there in 2 hours. Yeah, you're right.
I've done
it. Stupid to fly. Anyway, Liberty Bell. Have you seen the Liberty Bell?
I have not seen the Liberty Bell.
I have. That's the only good thing about Philadelphia is that they have the Independence Hall, the Liberty Bell, Betsy Ross's house, all within a little walking distance. Ben Franklin's thing right there, and it's really nice to walk around there. Yeah. The marketplace too.
Yeah,
very
nice.
Mm-hmm. Mall of America up there in Minneapolis.
No, I have not.
No, I haven't been. Even with Harmon Killebrew's little thing up there, I've not seen it. Mount Rushmore, of course.
Oh yes, yeah.
You've seen. I've not seen that.
I have not.
When you're close to it, and all of a sudden you see part of it in the distance, it's really exciting. I mean, and then when you get there, you think, oh wow, that really is cool. I'm sorry,
that's pretty cool. Yeah. Niagara Falls.
Slowly I toined. Why did they say toined?
I have not seen.
Abbott and Costello, man.
Have you seen Niagara Falls?
I have. Absolutely.
I have not seen.
Yeah, I have. In fact, I have a picture. Oh my God! I have a picture of me and Pete. Oh my God! I have a picture. Oh my God! I have a picture of me and Pete. Oh my God! I'm going to find this when I get home tonight. Of me and my one of my best friends, Pete Rice, went to Hotchkiss Prep School. He got a brand new Mustang, the 1964 summer 64. Graduated from Hotchkiss Prep School, and his dad bought him a Mustang convertible, the brand new 64 Mustang convertible, blue with a white top, and we drove that thing to Canada. And that's where I lost my friend from. But that girl who said, no to kiss, no to kiss. That was my summer story in his Mustang. And on the trip, we started by going to Niagara Falls. And I have a picture of me and him in our sport jackets standing right in the nighttime on a lamppost by Niagara Falls as we were heading into Canada to have me lose my virginity with a professional woman who was beautiful and wouldn't let me kiss her.
Okay. Let me get this straight. So you took a guy to America's honeymoon.
No, we were driving through the area to get to Montreal. Beg your pardon.
All right. You ever been to Pike's Peak?
Oh, you know, no, I don't think I have. I've driven so much in California when I lived there for a couple years, and I don't think I went to Pikes
Peak. It's in Colorado, Kim.
I thought Pikes it was in
Peak
California.
In Colorado. No, it's in
Colorado. It's in Colorado?
Yes, sir, Colorado.
I think you're lying to me now. It's in the desert of California.
Flounder, if you could look that up, please, and tell him it's another $5 he owes me.
It says $19. I bet you $19. Oh, sorry. All right,
it says Riverwalk. I'm only assuming that's San Antonio, Riverwalk.
Correct.
I have not been there.
I have not been there either.
All right. Okay. The Road to Hana, H-A-N-A. What the hell is that?
I don't know what that is.
I have no idea what that is. St. Augustine.
Yeah, yes.
Been there.
Oh, yeah. It's a great place. I love going to St. Augustine. South Beach.
Yes. Oh, yes. Yeah. Absolutely.
Did South Beach. Let's see. The Space Needle in Seattle.
Nope.
Flown over it. I've never been there.
Okay. Statue of Liberty.
Yes.
Yeah. Took the boat right next to it. The Alamo. Remember the Alamo?
No.
No, I have not been to the Alamo.
I haven't either.
I would like to go to the Alamo.
The White House.
Not been to the White House.
Yeah, we did the tour and everything.
Yeah, I didn't go in there, but I've been by it, but I've not been in it.
Oh.
I'll put a note.
Times Square.
Yes.
Oh, yes, of course.
Oh, yeah. New Year's Eve, 94, did it. It was great. Let's see. Walt Disney World.
Yes.
Yep.
Yep, did that. Washington Monument.
Yep. No.
Yep. Got to do that. Let's see. Brothers Memorial. I just did that a couple years ago. Wright Brothers of North Carolina.
No, I have not been there.
No.
That's pretty cool. Kitty Hawk's pretty good. The Outer Banks and everything. It's just
I've been to the Outer Banks. The Outer Banks is beautiful.
It's a great country.
Yeah. Yellowstone.
No.
No, sir.
That's on my bucket list.
Got to do it.
You've got to drive through Yellowstone. It's beautiful.
I want to.
And, let's see. Yosemite. One of the most beautiful places.
One of the greatest views I've ever had is when you're driving in the tunnel and you come out and you look at Yosemite Valley. It's one of the most beautiful things you will ever see.
There's Half Dome at the end of it. And it's just, and you take a little trip down the river. River's ice cold, but it's so gorgeous. Yosemite, you got to go to Yosemite.
Yeah.
It's the most beautiful place in America, I think. And Zion National Park.
That's on my bucket list as well.
I don't know where that is.
Isn't that Utah or something?
Yes.
Out there?
I've not been there.
Okay, what you got there, Cameron? How many have you been to?
Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I have 15 no's. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15. I have 19 yeses.
I have 16 yeses.
I got you. I got 21 and a half yeses.
10, 11, 12. I have 16 yeses. 17 yeses.
21 and a half.
Well, you're the traveling man. No question about it. So what do you win?
What do we win?
Well, golly, we're all out of time. All right, very quickly before we go, Virginia County unanimously voted to observe Transgender Day of Visibility on Easter Sunday. Fairfax Board of Supervisors, 9-0. Transgender Day of Visibility on Easter Sunday. Fairfax, Virginia.
Please.
Holy smokes. Coming up on 4 o'clock.
There they are. Guys, get them.
WFOM and W292EV Marietta on Dickey Broadcasting Station. This hour is presented by Atlanta Safe House.
There's no ordinary bridge. I'm Lisa Brady, Fox News. Those words from U.S. Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg moments ago in Baltimore, where the Francis Scott Key Bridge collapsed early today after being hit by a cargo ship that lost power.
This is one of the cathedrals of American infrastructure. It has been part of the skyline of this region for longer than many of us have been alive.
He says rebuilding will take time, pledging as much federal help as it takes. Right now, a search and rescue mission continues for 6 people unaccounted for. Independent presidential hopeful Robert F. Kennedy Jr. just announcing his running mate.
My fellow lawyer, a brilliant scientist, technologist, a fierce warrior mom, Nicole Shanahan.
She's also a philanthropist, the ex-wife of a Google co-founder. Kennedy says Shanahan shares his concern about big tech's role in what he calls the government's censorship, surveillance, and information warfare against the American people. He's still trying to get on the ballot around the country. About half of the states require a running mate for that process. An Idaho mayor says racist incidents targeting visiting college basketball players are believed to have been a serious threat to the students' safety. The driver of a truck with a Confederate flag yelling racist slurs at 2 two teams walking to dinner in Coeur d'Alene. Slurs that later continue, the mayor says, engines revving with others joining in. Mayor Jim Hammond.
I want to make it very clear and very loud that we condemn in the strongest terms those horrendous acts of hatred, and if the perpetrators can be found, we call upon them to be prosecuted.
The University of Utah women's basketball coach had said her team was subjected to racist incidents and moved hotels after arriving in Coeur d'Alene for the NCAA tournament. A mix of stocks finished lower, turning lower just before the bell. The Dow down 31 points. America's listening to Fox News.
Don't let everyday aches and pains keep you from living your best life.
I don't think I really understood what people meant when they talked about pain until I started feeling it myself.
Start feeling better every day with Relief Factor, a daily supplement designed to support your body's fight against aches and pains.
Not only do I move better without pain, I just feel better.
Created by doctors, Relief Factor uses a unique formula of natural ingredients that target four metabolic pathways to address pain. Relief Factor doesn't just mask aches and pains, it helps reduce or even eliminate them.
Today, I do the things I love, and it doesn't occur to me to think about pain.
You can feel the difference all day, every day.
Join the over 1 million people who have tried Relief Factor's 3-week quick start kit. It's only $19.95. Visit relieffactor.com or call 1-800-4-RELIEF. That's 1-800-4-RELIEF. And feel the difference of Relief Factor.
Ruff, ruff. Yeah, I'll be damned, my left ear just started working. 403, look out, here we go. It's Jan and Dean, baby. Hanging up on the right. Man. Sunset. If you got the nerve, race all the way. Dead Man's Curve. This was part of those songs where back in the 60s where the parents were all worried and the experts were all worried about the dead teenager songs. Racing cars and, tell Laura I love her and going back to get his high school ring. And there were a lot of them. And we all we took them to heart. They were moving and touching, and I thought how glorious and romantic that would be. Honestly, I mean, it really hit. It was the damn this thing, and we played that song because on this day in 2004, Jan Barry of Jan and Dean died at the age of 62. He had been in a car crash in 1966 and really never recovered. They had the 1963 hit "Surf City," co-written by Beach Boy Brian Wilson, at the hit of the height of their fame. Jan and Dean hosted. Jeez, I can't even speak. I'm sorry. Jan and Dean. I don't understand why I sometimes just don't read the words. It's just stupid. I don't think I'm having a stroke. Jan and Dean hosted and performed. I bet I'm getting lazy. I bet it's just I'm just kind of reading along instead of actually putting effort into it. Maybe I've just got to fire up myself a little bit more. I'm just things around my head and I got to get organized. Here we go. Jan and Dean hosted and performed at the TAMI show, featuring the Rolling Stones, Chuck Berry, James Brown, Marvin Gaye, the Supremes, and Smokey Robinson and the Miracles.
Flounder?
Much better.
Get the spoon ready. You may be fishing his tongue out of his throat in a minute or two.
Sooner than later.
Yeah, just pull. In fact, we had a guy who used to suffer epileptic fits in junior high school. And he would go running down. He would leave from class, and when he had it was a horrible seizure. It was just scary as hell. And he would have these horrible seizures, and he would start going, yelling like that. And they taught us that if it happened where you were, to hold him down and put a ruler in his mouth to keep his tongue from swallowing.
Okay, first of all, that turns out to be a myth. You cannot physically swallow your own tongue.
Right, but that's what they told me. This is 1958. you know, nobody knew anything about anything back then. So that's what they told us.
You thought your school desk could protect you from a thermonuclear device.
Yeah, duck and cover. Yeah, put your head over your hands over your head in the hallway. Yeah, let's all go in the hallway and kneel down and put your hands over your head.
Yeah, that'll work.
You'll be fine. Thermonuclear. Hey, we did it. We used to do it. Did you ever do it in school?
Practice? Tornado. Yeah, tornadoes, we go in the hallway and crouch down. Like, that's going to save us, down in the hallway.
No, but I mean for nuclear war. I bet you never had to go through that, did you?
No.
And Flounder, you probably never even heard of such a thing.
No, we had to do tornado drills and stuff like that.
No, we did nuclear war, man. Nuclear war. We were scared. I mean, it was a thing. And I'll tell you what, I was in prep school with the Cuban Missile Crisis. And there were some very serious talk. But anyway, whatever. Where was I? I don't even know where I was. Oh, here I was over here. How about a history thing? Here we go. 1969, speaking of the 60s. ABC TV aired the TV movie Marcus Welby with Robert Young, Father Knows Best Guy, and James Brolin. And that with a movie, they turned it into a series in 1969. And then in 1971, ABC aired a TV movie, Cannon, with William Conrad, and turned that into a series too, which what they used to do back then. They would start off with a movie and then make it into a series, and it lasted for quite a while. 4:07, Kimmer, Pete, and Flounder, how's it going? Our 4 o'clock hour brought to you by our good friends at Atlanta Safe House. They have a showroom in Acworth, you know. You need a safe if you don't know what you do. I'm telling you, don't put your Social Security card in your wallet. It goes in your safe, along with your living will and all that stuff. Tell them the Kimmer sent you, AtlantaSafeHouse.com. 408, hey, you want to give away tickets? Oh, we have a phone call? God, did we have a phone call? Flounder, I think I really screwed up.
You're good.
Is he still there?
No, he's not.
Oh, man, I'm so sorry. was it Mike?
I believe it was Mike.
Oh, crap. Mike, I'm sorry.
He wanted to re-gift you something that you gave a Kimmer babe 30 years ago.
I wrote it. Oh, God. Mike, I'm so... Please call back. I'm an idiot. I got all this stuff in here.
You're not good.
I'm not good. I'm not a man. It's over. I've got nothing left. I'm so sorry, Mike. Please call back. I don't know. I'll see what I can do. I'll give you one. I'll save something to give him as in return if he can't make it to see us on Friday when we're doing our show. And that's going to be, by the way, it's going to be pretty traumatic. It really is a thing. I'm getting a lot of feedback on Facebook over a thing I posted about. I think I'm giving away that magazine of me on the cover with my chopper on Hot Bike Magazine. And the reason I was thinking about it was because I'm fat. It was 2004, and I had cancer, and cancer treatments put me into male menopause. I gained about 40 pounds. I was having hot flashes. It was brutal for over a year, and I was all fat and stuff. And I was also, ironically, I also got divorced. I'll be damned. The link there. And at the same time, and that's why I had them build a Harley. Earl Small's Harley Davidson was my sponsor back then, and I had them build me a custom motorcycle. And because it was the time when I was getting divorced, I had them build me a chopper with only one seat, and I did it on purpose, and that was 20 years ago, almost to the day. And that magazine, that cover, really represents a turning point in my life 20 years ago, almost to the day.
20 years ago today, fat ass Kimmer got his chopper to play.
That's right. I still have the chopper, but the Screaming Eagle engine's dead. I mean, it died, and I have it in my garage. And so, but anyway, I mean, it would cost me 10 grand to fix it, and I'm not going to spend money on that thing. Anyway, 410. Okay, sorry. We got stuff here. I can't believe this business. Let's give away tickets. Should we give away tickets, Flounder? I've blown the whole segment already. Why not? It's 410. Okay,
sure.
Here's a number, 404-741-1230. And Mike, please call back. And I'm so sorry, but I'm an idiot.
Don't waste
Okay. We have a pair of tickets for opening night, May 7th, for the Broadway in Atlanta presentation of To Kill a Mockingbird. It's on May 7th. It's opening night. a Friday night, May 7th. The play is in To Kill a Mockingbird is in town for 8 shows between May 7th and 12th. You can get tickets at BroadwayInAtlanta.com. We're giving a pair of tickets away right now. Just call the number 404-741-1230 and Flounder will pick the girl who flirts with him the most, and we'll give away those tickets here shortly. And again, it's for May 7th, the opening night, Friday night at the Fabulous Fox Theater. Which is a reason enough alone to go. So anyway, and the phones are going nuts, so we'll have a winner here for you shortly. I mean, I can't believe this. Virginia County unanimously voted to observe its Transgender Day of Visibility on Easter Sunday. Critics, including everyone I could possibly think of, say this is intentionally trying to offend Christians on the holiest of days. Mm-hmm. Jesus Open Christ was in the thing with the wrist and risen from the thing with the up in the sky with the heaven and the sitting next to the God with the Father in the
Rose
seat.
From the dead.
Jesus,
Rose
Mary and
dead.
Joseph. That's like a big deal and the whole, you know, Christian world is. Am I wrong about it? Did I get this wrong, Peter? It's that whole thing where the cave and the wall and the God guards fell asleep and
they
stone.
They rolled the rock away.
The rock, and he went up in the air. I mean, that's like a big, you know, if I remember as an ordained minister,
it's
you
the
too.
The big thing.
Isn't that, my God.
Yeah, and it's an intentional open insult to all Christians everywhere.
It's unbelievable. Now they're saying, well, typically the day of visibility, Easter doesn't fall on the same day every year as Protestants and Catholics, and they can come as early as March 22nd or as late as April 25th. So I'm happy we're recognizing a community that has too often been pushed into the shadows and celebrating yet another community within our diverse tapestry here in Fairfax County, said one Democrat. The county 0.6%. Wants to make sure everybody who's a part of our community feels welcomed, feels loved, and feels empowered. I feel sick. Remember on Veterans Day when the women's group started coming out with something about abortion on Veterans Day? I said, my God, one lousy day for America's veterans, and you got to spoil it with something of a total political bullcrap? This is nonsense.
I'm calling for all trannies around the world to move to Fairfax County, Virginia, since they love you so much. Just take over that place.
Great place to go. By voting to make Easter this year Transgender Visibility Day, they're intentionally trying to offend Christians on the holiest day by enforcing gender ideology down their throats. This is reprehensible, unbecoming of our elected representatives. And, of course, the LGBTQ plus and all the alphabet people are going, oh, well, it's just a day to bring us out into the open. You know, we need this. Inclusion. Oh, my God. Holy God. I mean, Easter Sunday? Come on. You can't make a day and don't say, well, let's do it a day later. Or maybe do it Saturday so you can have a whole weekend. I mean, there it is. There's your news. Here's America. America 2024. Boom. All right, 414, Kipper, Pete, and Flounder. Oh, my God.
Time for the Bortz Report, brought to you by Southern Exteriors, the Southeast premier home exterior solution. Quality and precision you can rely on for over 20 years. Visit southernexteriors.co.
To the surprise of absolutely nobody who knows anything about law, an appeals court in New York yesterday lowered that $450 million bond, or whatever it was, down to $175 million and gave Donald Trump 10 days to pay it, which he will. Most Americans, I would dare say a big majority of Americans, don't understand what's going on here. All they know is that Donald Trump was ordered to pay $454 million to a court in New York, and if he didn't pay it by yesterday, the New York Attorney General was going to take away his property. That's the depth of the knowledge of most Americans. What most Americans may not realize or remember is, number one, Letitia James ran for Attorney General in New York on one primary platform. I'm going to get Trump. She didn't say how. She just said she was going to do it. Then she came up with this bit about, well, he overstated the value of his properties on a loan application. Who hasn't. As Jonathan Turley, law professor, George Washington University, said, there were no victims. There was no money lost. And when the judge ruled that Trump was guilty of this imaginary crime, he used as evidence the fact that Donald Trump said that Mar-a-Lago was worth way more than its actual worth, which the judge pinned at, what, $8, $10 million? I'm looking out the window of my condo at a house that's worth $28 million. And now we have companies afraid to do business in New York with Letitia James up there in Albany. A curse on these people for making me get on the air to defend Donald Trump. Not that anybody cares. Letitia James is probably a cat person. Neil Bortz, Extra 106.3.
Hey, homeowners. Tug here with some exciting news. Southern Exteriors is your one-stop solution for top-notch exterior services, from roofing to siding, windows, gutters, and more. No more waiting. They can start on your project immediately. And with an in-house warranty division, Southern Exteriors stands by their work for years to come. From leaky roofs to faded siding, trust Southern Exteriors for a quick and lasting transformation. Don't wait. Transform your home today. Call 877-9-SOUTHERN or visit southernexteriors.co now. Southern Exteriors, quality and precision you can rely on for over 20 years.
Buying a new car is about way more than just a car. You want to love it and everything that comes with it. And at Subaru of Gwinnett, we get that. You want to love the website. Easy to browse, easy to shop, and an unrivaled selection so you can find the model that suits you. Like the 2024 Subaru Outback, Crosstrek, or Ascent. All offering impressive gas mileage, standard symmetrical all-wheel drive, and the tools to explore the things you love. You want to love the people and know that every time you stop by the dealership on Satellite Boulevard in Duluth, they'll be there for you, ready to help in any way possible. And you want to love the service. We'll check that box for you also, because during the spring sales event, there's a lot to love. So stop in during the Subaru A Lot to Love event, and you'll find just that, a lot to love. Start your shopping online at SubaruofGwinnett.com and find the ride that best suits you, because love is what makes a Subaru a Subaru. Subaru of Gwinnett, Satellite Boulevard in Duluth, and online at SubaruofGwinnett.com.
I enjoy a good night's sleep, and I like to breathe while I'm sleeping. My wife appreciates that, too. That's why I wear a CPAP. You want the right machine. You want expert advice. You want all the supplies that go with it. You get it all at CPAPs, etc. in Alpharetta. Machines, masks, tubing, filters, cleaning supplies, all of it, and they ship nationwide. Walk-ins, by the way, are welcome. CPAPs, etc. Alpharetta, CPAPs, etc.com.
What are your plans for your business this year? Hey, it's Tug. Do you want to expand and grow? Aren't you exhausted by going to lenders, building a relationship, and a week later, you got a new person to deal with? You have to start all over again? You don't have that with First Liberty Building and Loan. The Frost family has been helping businesses grow since the 90s, and they want to know you. Unlike big banks, they want to partner with you. The Frost family knows the patterns. They know the ebbs and flows. They know business. Get to know them at FirstLibertyGA.com. Building a building, buying a building, buying a franchise, expanding. Reach out to them. Spend 10 minutes with them. See if you're a fit for them and if they're a fit for you. You do that at FirstLibertyGA.com. And by the way, if you're a young banker and want to work with a team that is faith-friendly and has a culture of excellence, First Liberty might be a good match. Reach out to them today. First Liberty Building and Loan. FirstLibertyGA.com. That's FirstLibertyGA.com.
Look out. It's Ozzy. It's Ozzy. Yeah, 420. 2002, their drummer Randy Castillo died of cancer. He was only 51. Randy worked with Ozzy Osbourne during the 80s and early 90s. He worked with Lita Ford and Motley Crue. And Randy Castillo died 51 years old of cancer. By the way, our congratulations to the Marietta Mike. Marietta Mike is our winner of our two tickets to go see opening night, May 7th, a Friday night, Broadway in Atlanta, presentation of To Kill a Mockingbird. Have a great time up there, Mike. 420, Kimmer, Pete, and Flounder. How's it going? Our birthday list includes my granddaughter, Molly, hit double digits, 10 years old. And I put a little video on Facebook of her with a little birthday cake party thing. Our birthday list includes Jennifer Grey. 64. Wow. 64. She was Baby in Dirty Dancing and Ferris's sister in Ferris Bueller's Day Off. And when she kicked that pervert in the face, the principal, that was a pretty funny scene. Anyway, she won season 11 Dancing with the Stars. I didn't know even she was, Jennifer Grey is 64 years old. And remember when she got her nose job, nobody recognized her in a right. million years. And she had to say, no, it's really me. Remember there was a whole thing where she actually was going on TV and they were doing stories. No, I swear to God, it's me. It's really me.
Good-looking woman.
Oh, my God. Totally changed her appearance. And good for her. I mean, whatever. And she seems like a nice girl. I don't know. I've never heard anything bad about her. Never been in a scandal that I know of.
Isn't she Joel Grey's daughter?
Yeah. Joel Grey, the famous cabaret type guy with Liza Minnelli and all back in the 50s, 60s, 70s. 70s, I guess, probably mostly.
70s.
Let's see. Birthday list, we did that. How about the history list thing? Here's how immigration has changed. 1910, on this day, Congress amended the Immigration Act to bar criminals, paupers, anarchists, and carriers of disease from settling in America. And now, anybody gets in, all you have to say is, I'm a refugee, they hurt me, I want to come. Okay, come on in, here's your bag of stuff, and we'll put you on a plane and go anywhere you want.
Why are you carrying your flag from your country?
Yeah, I just want to celebrate your own country again, do you? Or I thought you were fleeing your country, golly. Oh, I don't get it. I mean, just look at the pictures. How could anybody in their right mind not see all the video of all those people just coming in? They're just, here they come, they're walking in, you know, I mean, it's, oh, and by the way, my understanding is all those 100 people who attacked our National Guard troops the other day in Texas, apparently they're not going to be deported. I don't even know, I think they only arrested like one guy, and everybody else that got caught, they're not doing anything to them. They're not going to send them back.
Of course not.
Home.
Of course not.
Well, they're future Democrats, so why would they? It's unbelievable. Honestly, just unbelievable. I still don't understand the Baltimore Francis Scott Key Bridge collapse business.
A structural engineer just asked the question I asked. How does hitting one of those pylons bring the entire mile and a half down?
Yeah, I know. I know. I have to assume it's like the same power of like some kind of kinetic energy, the same way when the airplanes on 9/11 hit the top of the World Trade Center, the whole thing collapsed. The power of it and everything else. I can understand. I can see that.
But one ship can bring down an entire bridge. That's just amazing.
If any pylon collapses, again, the bridge is connected from pylon to pylon. So the section of the bridge that's on top of that pylon that's now in the water is going in the water.
The whole thing
didn't collapse. Only the middle of it. I just saw a video on Fox. I've got the TV on here, and they showed video on the daylight picture right now. The ship is still at the bridge. The bow of the ship is still at the bridge, and the bridge is only half gone. I mean, there's still an entrance and an exit to the bridge. Either end of it is still there. The middle part is what collapsed.
But see, for a bridge to be fully operational,
you really should have the one end.
Well,
again, you know,
the other end.
You really should have a middle. You know,
and then the middle part.
Well, you have to, if you have the middle, you're pretty much okay. I'm not an engineer. I'm not a biologist. You know,
technically, is it a bridge if there's no middle?
Well, if it's not a middle, it's really just a hole. It's just kind of a hole in the. Oh, Lord. I still can't buy. If you see the video, those freaking cars are going six seconds before the thing hit.
All of it didn't fall down. Just the most important part.
Yeah, the part
like
where
the
you
middle.
Can drive on it. Yeah. I'm just saying. I mean, so I understand.
The part over the water.
Well, I can see structurally why that would happen. But I don't understand. Well, we need to know when the power of the ship went out. Was he steering properly to go under the bridge? And then 5 seconds before he hit the thing, power went out? I don't think that's the case
at
all.
It went out twice. You see it on the video. It went out twice.
Yeah. Well, now, see, I find it hard to believe that they still had anybody that they didn't block the bridge immediately.
And for them to right off the top say, this is not terrorism, they don't know.
No, they don't know. Well, it's probably unlikely. A cargo ship, that would be the last
thing. Well, the thing is you look, I mean, again, and there was...
You wouldn't do it at 1 o'clock in the morning. You'd do it at rush hour if you were going to do it. Terrorism.
But it seems like did someone hack their power? Because their power, they didn't have power two different times.
That would be.
But like you said, if you were going to do something like that, you would do it during traffic hour or something like that.
Yeah.
Not
but,
unless you just wanted to stop trade.
Well, that's true. Again, in fact, I think they do $3 billion worth of trade. There are 15,000 jobs at the Baltimore port. I mean, this is a major thing until they get
the price of crab is going to go through the roof.
Well, yeah, well, you got your whole crab price here. It's unbelievable.
How's this affect me?
Crab, you got your crab. Davis. You got your crab cakes. You got your crab stew. You got your crab chowder. You got your
crab biscuit. Crab chowder.
Oh, my God. Chowder. 426, Kimmer, Pete, and Flounder. 40474. Oh, God. All right. I forgot. Let's do something amusing. Flounder.
And here's the thing. Americans do not understand statistics. We really don't. Check this out. These are true headlines. I couldn't even make these up. This is true. Statistics show that teen pregnancy drops off significantly after age 25. That is shocking. I would have thought it dropped off, I don't know, around 20, I would have guessed. Pretty much down to zero, but no, it hangs on for five more years. Here's some other ones. We hate masks, say 4 in 10. A majority of Americans. Clearly, they're not in a STEM program. Death is the nation's top killer. Really? Did we need a study for that? Homicide victims rarely talk to police. Have they been trying to get them information? Problem up, Bob. Who the hell killed you, buddy? You're not helping anybody here.
That is Don McMillan, and that was brought to you by Nucky's Hoagies, which where you guys will be Friday, located in Roswell Corner Shopping Center, owned by the Sub-Sisters.
The Sub-Sisters, who are big fans of this radio station, which we are glad to
They're
see.
They're listening right now.
And that naughty little Stacy and her naughty little sister, those sub-girls there, the one, and Stacy said,
they're going to have all their mom's
I'm
friends
I'm going to tell
out.
All of my, and I got excited, I'm going to all of my mom's friends to be there for the camera. So I, thank you.
Empty the home.
Yeah. We're going to put in a special wheelchair ramp, I'm pretty sure, and some kind of a braille entrance of feeling touch to get in the doorway for the Kimmer section.
I have more vans.
You ever notice braille on drive-thrus?
I know what there is.
I don't understand that. Why are those there?
I think it's because if you were actually walking or on a bike or something and you wanted to go to the ATM, you could use an ATM. But still, it is funny every time I see it. Oh, by the way, the other day at Publix, somebody left one of those little love messages of the little, like a little flower with a bow on it and a love note saying, you're wonderful and have a great day or something and share this with someone else. Every once in a while, I put a video of it a few months ago. Someone did that. They put it on the ATM machine. And it's a little, like a little flower and a note and a little bow on it. And it just says, you know, have a nice day and share this with someone to make them feel better. Something like that. A little note on it. It's just a weird thing.
In this age of fentanyl, you walk around picking those
things up? I looked at it. I took a video of it, but I think I left it right the hell there. Because it could have been a bomb in there. Could have been, you know, well, hey.
A love bomb.
I just love the smell of napalm in the morning. You know, when you worry about punji sticks and all those things, I mean, I tell you what, you somebody scared a crap out of you. They tell you cigarette snakes. If you get bit, you've got time to light a cigarette, and that's it. Boom. I mean,
is that like the Fertile Lance there in Vietnam? Is that what they have there?
I don't know.
That snake?
Yeah, but it's not.
Green mambas and stuff?
Yes. Cigarette snakes, they call them. Because you got time to fire up a lucky, and that's a ball game.
The scariest thing is in Africa, the video showing black mambas, those real long ones, chasing people down the road. Yeah.
They also have poisonous snakes that spit their poison. Have you seen those?
Cobra.
Holy. I mean, they spit a lot of it and a long way. And if it gets in your eyes, that's a ball game.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, my God. It's 4:30. I can't believe it. I blew the whole segment again, Flounder. It's my fault. We had new stuff coming up. We'll talk about Trump's wealth. Idiot Democrats. And DeSantis and the under-14 social media law. Stand by. Kimmer, Pete, and Flounder. 4:30. Look out.
Hey, it's Rhino from The Morning Extra, getting your weekday morning started from 6 to 10 a.m. When you don't get your way and you decide to go to Portland, light a federal building on fire. That's a threat to democracy. Setting up an autonomous zone in Seattle, that's a threat to democracy. Going and standing in front of a court case and using mob mentality to try to change a ruling, that's a threat to democracy.
The Morning Extra, 6 to 10 a.m. on Extra 106.3 FM and the Extra app.
Join A Second Chance Bail Bond CEO Daniel Madelon and host Tug Coward for the weekly radio show Back Your Blue. They will highlight special initiatives, criminal justice programs, and community events aimed at keeping our communities safer. Tune in Saturdays at 10 a.m. to learn some good news about and from the law enforcement and justice communities. This week's guest is Mike Lutzenkirchen from the Lutze 43 Foundation. Tune in on Saturdays or catch up on all past episodes wherever you get your podcasts or at the podcastpark.com.
No one plans on going to jail, but when it happens, it's important that you know who to call. Call A Second Chance Bail Bonds, where we believe everyone deserves a second chance. Whether your loved one's been arrested in Cherokee, Clayton, or any of the other metro Atlanta counties in between, A Second Chance Bail Bonds works fast to help expedite release within hours. A Second Chance. It's better to know us and not need us than need us and not know us. Call A Second Chance 24/7 at 770-627-3235. Or online at atlbail.com.
Central Heating and Air Conditioning wants you to know the start of the new season is the perfect time to ensure your home's comfort. Don't wait like most people do to have your HVAC system serviced. Your home should have maintenance twice a year. Maintenance helps keep your system running at peak efficiency and extends the life of your equipment. So turn to Atlanta's Carrier experts for your system's maintenance. With Central, you get Carrier products, Carrier warranty, and Carrier peace of mind. It's allergy season, and Central Heating and Air can fix what ails your house and possibly your family with home ventilation and air quality products. Central has packages designed around health using variable speed, fresh air ventilation, air cleaners, air purifiers, dehumidifiers, and more. Central Heating and Air is one of the few second-generation, locally owned and operated HVAC companies in Atlanta. With Central, you're not just a number, you're a member of the family. It's been that way since 1947, and they've serviced over 100,000 customers right here in Atlanta. Call 770-GET-HEAT or go to centralheat.com.
We're smart, we care, we're Central Heating and Air.
Hey there, it's Tara, owner and publisher of Our Town Monthly, where you'll find familiar faces, local voices, and community businesses like JRM Management.
Thanks, Tara. I'm Missy Miller, event coordinator at JRM Management. We are your event specialist. We're excited to see you at the Georgia Food and Wine Festival, March 21st through the 24th. We'll have food, beverages, cooking demos, live music, shopping, and more. Or maybe you're looking for an event where you can bring the entire family. Join us at the Marietta Community Egg Hunt Friday, March 29th, and the Northeast Cobb Community Egg Drop Saturday, March 30th. There will be multiple egg hunts by age and lots of kid-friendly activities. Also, look out for the Kennesaw Big Shanty Festival, the Smyrna Spring Jonquil Festival, and of course, the North Georgia State Fair. There's always something fun happening in our community, and we want you to know about it. That's why we love our partnership with Our Town Monthly.
You are so right, Missy. If JRM is there, the fun follows. Friends, check out all the exciting community events hosted by JRM Management. And remember, Our Town is your town at Our Town Monthly.
Hey there, it's Janelle King, host of the Janelle King Show, right here on Extra 106.3 FM, where we are unafraid and unapologetic. We explore the topics that matter the most. You can catch us on Saturdays at 4 p.m. and encore episode on Sundays at 9 a.m. And catch up on past episodes by going to the podcast park right here at Extra 106.3 or wherever you get your podcasts every single Tuesday. Until then, stay unafraid, stay unapologetic, and never stop seeking the truth.
True Prep on Cobb Parkway is your one-stop shop for emergency preparedness supplies, including freeze-dried food, water filtration, first aid, and more. They also have a large selection of firearms, including a huge selection of AR-15s, firearm accessories, and ammo at the lowest prices around. They are locally owned and operated. You can visit their store in Marietta on Cobb Parkway or online at trueprep.com. That's TRUprep.com. Prepare today for a worry-free tomorrow at True Prep.
Millions
of guys suffer from erectile dysfunction.
That's one in four men. And I can tell you, I'm one of them.
If you or someone you know suffer from ED, Peyronie's disease, or PE, here's 38-year emergency room doctor and founder of Total Body Therapy of Georgia, Dr. Eric Deal.
Patients who enter my office are often frustrated, hopeless, depressed, and embarrassed. I understand the problem, and I'm going to help you fix it. There are lots of competitors that don't have the credentials that I have. When you go to other clinics, you're not going to see board-certified physicians with the experience that I have. When you come to our clinic, you're going to see me. There's just not one therapy that can solve these complex issues. I'll do a complete history and physical prior to any treatment that we use. Take it from me, Dr. Deal. When it's not hard, it's really hard.
Call Dr. Deal for your free one-on-one evaluation and resolve your ED, Peyronie's, or PE issues. Total Body Therapy of Georgia, 404-777-1911. 404-777-1911. Online at StopMyED.com.
Dun-dun-dun-dun. Little Stevie. I remember Little Stevie Wonder when he was Little Stevie. Oh, my goodness. Radio stations in South Africa didn't think much of Little Stevie Wonder on this day in 1985, because the night before, Stevie Wonder... Well, I was waiting for him to sing there. Stevie Wonder saluted Nelson Mandela when Stevie won the Academy Award at the ceremony, won the Oscar. And as a result, the next day, all the radio stations in South Africa banned his records. And so, there you go. 437. Kimmer, Pete, and Flounder. And our birthday list includes Amy Smart is 48. The girl Ashton Kutcher tries to save in the butterfly effect. And T.R. Knight is 51, formerly Dr. George O'Malley on Grey's Anatomy. Anybody will watch that show? I watched the first year of that because I was had a little girl thing going there. One history thing, just quickly, on this day, 1982, after 2 years of fundraising, groundbreaking ceremonies began in Washington, D.C. for the Vietnam Veterans Memorial. A pair of 200-foot black granite walls with the names of Americans killed, missing in action. I've never been there, but I saw the moving wall came here many years ago, and so it's touching, it's moving, and I saw names that, you know, it'll hit you. Yes, sir.
We were talking earlier about the terrorism possibility with this and hacking into the ship.
Yeah. Computer system.
Last year, and you saw this, I think you did, Flounder, that movie Leave the World Behind that the Obamas produced.
Yes.
On Netflix.
Where they hated America, hated white people.
No,
this
happened. A cyber attack caused a massive container ship to lose power and crash.
I'll be damned.
Now it's happened.
Well,
it's blatant, right? It's right in our face, is what it is. It's right in our face.
Wow. I don't know why no one said yet. There must be someone must know the time of when the power went out, how long the captain had to warn the people on the bridge that the ship was going to hit the bridge. I mean, I can't believe that anybody was still driving over that bridge. And the video shows the guy 5 seconds before the ship hit.
No, that's because it was a time lapse. It was the video's going faster so you can see it. So that the video is probably going 3 to 4 times as fast as a normal.
Are you serious? Really?
Yeah, because when you see the bridge fall, it falls much faster than the live shot. Yeah. So when they're, because the reason they did that is you get to see the ship losing its power 2 different times.
Because
again, like you said, the ship's going slow, but at the same time it's moving.
Okay, well, and still, why was anybody on the bridge? Why were the guys fixing potholes on the bridge when the freaking ship hit?
Where's that?
And why were there cars on the bridge? You went into the water. They did sonar and it showed cars in the water. Therefore, people and cars were still on the bridge. How is that possible?
Well, rest assured, your president is on top of the situation.
Oh,
he has made
a
statement.
Oh, here we go.
According to the libs of TikTok, Biden is now claiming he commuted over the Francis Scott Key Bridge by train many times. The bridge does not have any rail lines. No trains run over that bridge.
He's actually said that?
Yeah, he just said it.
Oh, my God. And by the way, he's already announced that the federal government, your taxpayer money, is going to pay for it to fix the bridge, even though it's clearly the shipping company's fault that they broke the bridge.
Maybe
so why should we pay for it? Have the shipping company pay for it?
Are they dim donors?
Well, I mean, even so, how can you possibly say, Biden says, well, we'll get Congress to pay for it. Well, now, wait a minute. Who the hell you think you are? I mean, this is, you know, well, we'll take another $5 billion off of the student loans for gender studies, well, too.
I have no problem for the government paying for it to get it up fast, but then they need to be reimbursed by the company.
Well, they needed to go private. They need to have private enterprise build that bridge back, the same way Trump did and Florida did. Remember when the hotel thing collapsed and all this stuff happened in Florida? Man, they put that thing back in about 2 weeks. And it wasn't because of the federal government. And anyway, I the whole thing is just making me nuts. 440. Oh, by the way, here's the latest on Donald Trump. It's now they're going after him again. New York judge, the one who's in the so-called hush money case, the New York judge, Juan Merchan, is now imposing a gag order on Donald Trump concerning payments made in the hush money case. This is the Stormy Daniels thing where he tried to pay her off to not say things. The judge ordered Trump cannot make or direct others to make public statements about witnesses concerning their participation or about the other attorneys in the case other than Bragg, the DA, or the court staff or the DA staff or family members of the staff. Trump cannot make public comments or direct others to do it on the jurors or chosen jurors. He said Trump has made statements in the past during other trials, referring to the months-long non-jury thing with the the teacher James. Indeed, the statements he made then, the judge says, were threatening, inflammatory, denigrating, and the targets of his statements range from local and federal officials, court and court staff, prosecutors, private individuals, grand jurors performing their civic duty. The consequences include not only fear on the part of individuals, but also the assignment of increased security resources to investigate the threat. Oh, my God. Donald Trump says this is unconstitutional. It's a freaking gag order against my freedom of speech, my First Amendment rights. You know, he has a right running for president, the leading candidate, to say what he's entitled, the highest level of protection under the First Amendment. Manhattan DA Alvin Bragg, the director of Crooked Joe Biden, at his direction chose to indict Trump in the middle of a campaign season, politically motivated attempt to derail his candidacy. And worst of all, the gag order violates the civil rights of over 100 million Americans who follow Donald Trump and have a right to hear what he says. We have American voters have a fundamental right to hear the uncensored voice of the leading candidate for the highest office in the land. President Trump will keep fighting for our country and our Constitution. Good. I mean, it's unbelievable. They just can't stop. Oh, my God. And now we're having tranny visibility today on Easter in Fairfax County, Virginia. Oh, my God. 443, Kermit, Pete, and Flounder. How you doing? Here's the number, 404-741-1230, 741-1230. Oh, Pete tells me some good news. If you drive on the northern half of I-285, man, I will do anything to avoid driving on I-285 on the north end, the top end perimeter. Yeah, either, especially going east, but, you know, from the middle point going east in particular, the potholes and the cracks, the giant leaping crack crevices in that highway.
It's both sides, east and west.
Both directions, but I can't believe it.
Over by Perimeter Mall, it's terrible.
Oh, yeah, my God.
It's been there for a decade like that.
For years.
Years.
Years. And now, do I hear you telling me they're finally going to fixing it?
I saw on Facebook that Crash Clark, who does the traffic, I think, for 11 Alive, was saying they're milling it or whatever. And it looks like they're putting new asphalt on it.
They would be, because that's technically part of the whole rebuild where they're doing the 285-400 merge and all that stuff.
Yeah. But that's been going on for years. Yes. I mean, I remember, man, you don't want to drive on. Yeah, it's not good. Well, that's a good
thing. Imagine coming through Atlanta from somewhere else and seeing that and thinking, what's going on here?
Oh, by the way, I just thought of something. Last night, I told Flounder earlier, last night I'm watching Jesse Waters, so I'm working on the show, and I thought I was wrong. And by the way, Jesse Waters is getting a little too full of himself to me. All those Fox hosts are,
He's always been a little full of himself.
It's getting overboard. And the same with that one who's on before him. I can't remember her name. I can't stand her. The interrupter.
Laura Ingraham?
Oh, God. Anyway, so Jesse Waters last night is coming to the end of the segment. He says, I forgot who the guest was. It might have been, I can't remember who it was. And he said, okay, thanks. We got to go. And a guy said, "Oh, Jesse, before you go, I want to tell you one thing." He says, "Oh, we're out of time." And he says, "Oh, 10 seconds. And Jesse says, I don't have 10 seconds. And he says, "Well, you've used it up now by doing this." And Jesse finally says, "Oh, okay, GD it." And he said GD, the word, skull darn, on Fox television last night. Okay, I'll run it. And I couldn't believe it. I mean, wow.
Wow.
And I haven't heard any reaction. I know I haven't been. I haven't looked. Maybe there's something on Twitter, X, or whatever, yeah, social media, but I haven't seen a thing. And I couldn't believe
you,
it.
Sir, you have the good taste to say it right before we go back on air, which sometimes felt.
Yeah, but sometimes I let the audience hear by mistake.
If I say bad words, I always apologize. If I, you know, and to the big.
There's been times where I've had where he's been in the other room and he said GD and he goes, "Sorry, God." Says after.
Then you know it's time to dump, hit the dump button. I always apologize.
Sorry. Well, I'm telling you, I hate that word. I try never to use that word. It's usually when there's pain inflicted or something like that, and it just comes out. But I'm telling you, if used right in a comedic sense,
it's the only best way
it
there
makes
is.
Things a thousand times funnier.
Sorry, God. 446, Kevin Pete and Flounder, and the good Lord himself on 106.3. I'm hoping. It's almost Easter.
The Kimmer Show is only live on Extra 106.3 every weekday afternoon on your drive home.
And the only person arrested and so far reprimanded in any way for the Afghanistan withdrawal is the dead Marine's father.
All these arrests are a signal that you will not question the regime.
The Kimmer Show, every afternoon from 3 to 6 p.m. on Extra 106.3 and the Extra app.
Atlanta, it's Mark from the Safe House. And now, the security riddle of the day. What's less secure than a fake safe from a furniture big box store? Joe Biden's fake border policy, of course. But hey, there is good news. This time next year, Joe Biden will not be president. So drop by Atlanta Safe House and check out the largest selection of safes in the Southeast. Build a wall around your valuables with a safe from the Safe House. We have certified delivery crews to install your safe. With over 30 years in the safe business, the Safe House is the place to buy a safe in Georgia. So go to AtlantaSafeHouse.com.
Jim Nearchus here with exciting news. The All Four Seasons Home Show returns to Atlanta Radio this Saturday morning at 9, bringing you advice and tips from some of Georgia's top business owners. Join Dan Watkins and myself when we will be helping you make smarter purchases, save money, and keep from getting ripped off. That's the All Four Seasons Home Show every Saturday morning at 9, right here on Extra 106.3.
Hey, it's Front Office Lowe's for Underdog Fantasy. The NBA season is still here, and there's no easier way to get in on all the action than with Underdog Fantasy and their Pick'em game. It's a fantasy game, but you can win real money. It's easy. Pick 2 to 5 players from at least 2 different teams. Select higher or lower on the player stats, and if your pick hits, you can win up to 100 times your money. It's legal in Georgia, and it's a ton of fun to play as you can watch the Atlanta Hawks. Stop playing against the pros night in and night out with their hundreds of different lineups. It's just you against the stat. It's that easy. Underdog Fantasy is even easier to get started. Go to their easy-to-use mobile app or to underdogfantasy.com. Sign up and use the promo code LOS, and Underdog will match your first deposit up to $100. Plus, they'll give you a mystery special pick to use on your first pick of entry. That's Underdog Fantasy. Promo code LOS, L-O-S, to get your first deposit of 10 or more matched, plus your special pick. Must be 18 and present in state where Underdog Fantasy operates. Terms apply. Concerned with your play? Call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit ncpgambling.com.
The 2024 season is just around the corner, and the Braves' home schedule is jam-packed with great matchups and even better promotions. The Braves open at home against the defending NLCS champion Arizona Diamondbacks April 5th through the 7th, followed by the New York Mets April 8th through the 11th. The Braves will honor all of their 2023 award winners in a special pregame ceremony on April 6th, and on April 8th, the Braves will then honor the 50th anniversary of Hank Aaron's record-breaking 715th home run with a special Hank Aaron bobblehead giveaway together with Truist.
There's a new home run champion of all time, and it's Henry Aaron.
And
And the second half of April continues with another great giveaway featuring Ronald Acuna Jr.'s 2023 Stolen Bases Record Bobblehead Giveaway presented by Xfinity on April 24th. And two Blooper Kids giveaways on April 21st and the 28th. Visit Braves.com/promos to get your tickets and check out all of the fun planned this April. Atlanta Braves Baseball, we are Braves Country.
Greetings, naturopathic Dr. Dennis Black here, founder of Rough Greens. Rough Greens is not dog food, but because dog food is dead food, it needs to be supplemented with live, powerful nutrition. Go ahead, take a bowl of your dog's kibble and put it on a shelf and see what happens after 2 to 3 years. You know what happens? Nothing. No mold, no bacteria, nothing happens. Because you know why? There's nothing alive in it. Dogs need live nutrition, which is why I formulated Rough Greens. With live vitamins, minerals, probiotics, omega oils, and so much more to help your dog with all of their health issues. I'm so confident that Rough Greens will help. My dogs and I will send you a free Jumpstart trial bag so your dog can try it before you buy it. You don't have to change your dog's food to improve their health. Just sprinkle on a little Rough Greens. They'll love it, and it's an easy and smart way to get your dog feeling better and living longer. A free Jumpstart trial bag can be yours. You just cover the shipping. Go to roughgreens.com. That's RUFFgreens.com.
Here we go. Wait till you hear this. Coming up, 4:51, Kimmer, Pete, and Flounder. And on this day, 1980, the Police became the first Western pop group to play in Bombay, India, for over 10 years when they played a one-off gig in the city, Bombay. 1980, Police.
We prefer Mumbai.
Mumbai. Is that what it is now? Bombay, yes. Is now Mumbai? Well, how are you supposed to keep track of this kind of thing? Anyway. And let's see. Our birthday list includes Vicki Lawrence. I always thought she was kind of cool. Vicki Lawrence, she was on the Carol Burnett Show, Mama's Family.
One of the worst three songs of all time.
Well, yeah, the night they drove all down in Georgia, whatever it was.
The night the lights went out in Georgia.
Lights went out, yeah. They drove with Dixie down was at Joan Baez or whatever, the other one.
Yeah, both suck.
I think that's kind of cruel. I think it was a popular song. It was a nice, so pleasant song.
It was a crap on the South, so they can go kiss Tootie.
I don't remember it being a crap on the
both
South.
Both songs. They can both just eat a donut for all I care.
Oh, my God. Well, I'm sorry I brought it up. I was going to say something nice. I've changed my mind now.
Finally, Carol Burnett.
Vicki, that scummy little slut, Vicki Lawrence, that trampy little puke-headed little scumbag, an abortionist, 75 years old today. Why doesn't she die a horrible death soon? Just to make you feel better. God. Mama's Family, Carol Burnett Show, Jesus.
A lot of pent-up anger over here.
Oh, my God, man. Pluck her fingernails out, why don't you? Jeez. Anyway, on Carol Burnett Show, of course, Carol Burnett. Everybody who's been kissed by Carol Burnett, could you raise your hand, please, everybody? Anybody else who's been kissed by Carol Burnett and had their picture in the paper all over the world? Anybody else? I'm sorry. By the way, Carol Burnett, we just hit her birthday the other day, and I remember one of her famous lines was, it was last year, I think. I can't remember the name she used this year, but last year somebody said, Carol Burnett, wow, you're 93 years old. Is there anything you want to do for your birthday? She said, yeah, George Clooney. I mean, pretty clever for a girl in her 90s. Anyway, so Carol Burnett and Vicki Lawrence. So that's our birthday list on today. And coming up, you'll be excited to know that after 5 o'clock, I'm going to talk about the March of Dimes. A big deal on this day. And how a famous world hero was blasted by his own peers. But first, on this day in 1937, spinach growers... Big industry in Crystal City, Texas. Spinach growers in Crystal City, Texas, on this day in 1937, erected a statue of Popeye the Sailor Man.
There was some erection, let me tell
you. It was the Murgatroyd, olive oil.
They really can't.
Underrated movie. Popeye. Robin Williams. Yeah, underrated
Robin Williams.
Movie.
Yeah. And who is that? The skinny girl who played in that other freak movie with
Shelley Duvall.
Yeah, man. Wasn't she the Jack Nicholson one through the wall? Here's Johnny. Whatever that. I can't remember the name. Oh my God, Shelley Duvall.
Shining.
Shining.
Hey.
Yeah.
You mentioned earlier the fingernail thing.
Yeah.
About the
pulling fingernails,
the Vietnamese used to do. The other day, I stuck my hand in my bag, and I caught a business card, and it went halfway under the nail. Yeah.
Oh, that's as bad as it gets.
It is. It's pretty
bad. As bad as it gets.
Because you can't get anything under there
to make
it feel better.
No, you can't. You have to soak it in something that doesn't work, and it just burns. Yeah, it's, oh, God. It's like a sliver under. Yeah. Oh, mercy. I'm such a coward. I swear to God, if they ever captured me, I was going to kill myself. I told everybody before I left, too, I'm not going to be taking you alive. I'm too much of a chicken. I know I spilled the beans. They're over there. $4.55. I don't want
John McCain would have crawled into your cell and strangled you.
Killed me.
At night.
He would have cut and choked me to death.
Put a pillow over your head.
I would have said, please do. I would. The last thing I would ever want to do would be anyway. $4.55. Can repeat and flounder. Mercy. Donald Trump, when the Truth Social went in public, now the figure is now Donald Trump's net worth is about $6.4 billion. He now joins the world's top 500 richest people. First, let's do that story. I got distracted. Flounder, clicked me and reminded me. Listen to this. We've been talking about the bridge collapse, Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore. President Puke Brain Murderer has now claimed that we are going to pay for it with American tax dollars. But listen to what he says. Listen to what he says at the podium about this bridge. Listen very carefully to your president.
At about 1:30, container ship struck the Francis Scott Key Bridge, which I've been over many, many times commuting from the state of Delaware in our trainer by car.
One problem, the bridge doesn't have any train tracks. There is no train. Reaction. He nearly lost the bridge in his kitchen to a ship collision and his son died in it. It didn't require esoteric knowledge of border policy to realize how this would play out. And the people still argue with me that this man's not fit for presidency. I know what it's like to lose a bridge. I lost a son. Oh, my God. Biden probably thinks he had to use the Francis Scott Key to unlock the doors to the train. He's not fit to be president. His brain is off the tracks. Oh, my God. He's not stupid. He has dementia. If I only had the thing. Good Lord. Diddy officially endorses Joe Biden, launches his own political party. Oh, my Lord. I mean, Flounder, play it again, please, if you would, sir. Here's your president addressing the tragedy at the bridge in Baltimore.
At about 1:30, container ship struck the Francis Scott Key Bridge, which I've been over many, many times commuting from the state of Delaware in our trainer by car.
Mm-hmm. There is no train track on that bridge at all. There, it's pathetic. And by the way, it's no longer funny. I am absolutely outraged at this man and his freaking stinking cuckold wife, the enabler. She should have grabbed him by the neck the day he was elected, 4 years ago, and said, "Joe, that's it. You did it. You pulled it off, and now you're going to be a one-term president, and don't even think about it." And she should have grabbed him and stopped it. And all the Democrats have said, okay, we did it. We pulled it off. Let's do all we can, but you're not going to do this again. This is a disgrace. He's a disgrace. He's a fraud. He's a fake. He's a dangerous individual. And I'm sick and tired of this crap with you. He's just telling stories. It's no big deal. My ass, it's no big deal. This is the president. You got to be kidding with me. He's making up stuff. He can't help it. They're laughing at us all over the world. I mean, seriously.
He is the Vicky Lawrence of government.
Oh, my God, man. You just can't let it go. I'm surprised you haven't put a hit out on her. I want her dead. I want her family dead. I want her house burned to the ground.
She's a slippery one, that Lawrence.
The lights went out, and so did she. My God, man. Let it go. It's almost 5 o'clock. Yowie.
WFOM and W292EV Marietta, a Dickey Broadcasting Station. This hour is presented by Lee Brandt Jewelry and Watches.
Six people remain missing. Lisa Brady, Fox News, says the search continues in frigid waters where the Francis Scott Key Bridge collapsed early today in Baltimore.
We are still actively looking for survivors. We know, and that's the pledge we've made to these families, and this is still very much an active search and rescue mission.
Maryland Governor Wes Moore alongside Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg.
As President Biden has made clear, the federal government will provide all of the support that they need for as long as it takes.
The president saying earlier today he wants the federal government to pay for reconstruction. The NTSB is investigating what appears to have been an accident. A container ship lost power and hit one of the bridge's support beams. The governor says bridge workers saved lives, quickly stopping cars from entering after the ship issued a Mayday call just before impact. Giorgio Comnenos lives in Baltimore.
I just couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe that the key bridge had collapsed.
He felt it.
I heard a really loud rumble. My entire house was shaking almost as though we were in the midst of an earthquake.
Comnenos says the port is the heartbeat of the community with local businesses depending on it, in addition to larger operations, including fulfillment centers for Amazon and other companies, and that losing a critical connection point will have vast consequences. Robert F. Kennedy Jr. taps a fellow former Democrat as his running mate, Nicole Shanahan, a lawyer and philanthropist who shares his concerns.
Among other things, she has used over the past several years cutting-edge technology, including AI, to calculate the catastrophic health consequences of toxins in our soil, our air, our water, and our food.
Having a running mate is part of the application process to get on the ballot in many states. America is listening to Fox News.
Don't let everyday aches and pains keep you from living your best life.
I don't think I really understood what people meant when they talked about pain until I started feeling it myself.
Start feeling better every day with Relief Factor, a daily supplement designed to support your body's fight against aches and pains.
Not only do I move better without pain, I just feel better.
Created by doctors, Relief Factor uses a unique formula of natural ingredients that target 4 metabolic pathways to address pain. Relief Factor doesn't just mask aches and pains, it helps reduce or even eliminate them.
Today, I do the things I love, and it doesn't occur to me to think about pain.
You can feel the difference all day, every day.
Join the over 1 million people who have tried Relief Factor's 3-week quick start kit. It's only $19.95. Visit relieffactor.com or call 1-800-4-RELIEF. That's 1-800-4-RELIEF. And feel the difference of Relief Factor.
Ruff, ruff. Together, ladies. Left shoulder, right a blank. Ready on your dog, target. Herp, 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 daddy, little herp, lock and load. Herp, 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 ride your road guards out. Herp, herp, baby, daddy, little. Look out. It's only me, it's only the Kimmer, with Pete Davis and Philander, 5:03 and a half, actually, on 106.3. How's it going? It's Tuesday. I hate Tuesdays. I kind of like Wednesday because it means it's almost Thursday. I like Thursday because it's almost Friday. So, but Tuesday sucks, so there you are. Anyway, here's the number. We love phone calls, 404-741-1230. In fact, we have Helen coming up here in just a moment, 404-741-1230. And also, My apologies to earlier caller Mike, who called in and I didn't get to him and he had to hang up. So, Mike, please call back because I felt terrible that I'm an idiot. And we'll get to hell in here in just a second. 404-741-1230. Kim, Pete, and Flounder talking about the bridge collapse. And again, we're going to play this soundbite another couple of times of President Stupid Face, the murderer, saying that he used to take the car and train route over that bridge many times on commuting from Delaware. There is no train track on that bridge. He could not have taken a train to commute from Delaware over that bridge. And his son did not die in Iraq, you know, charging a machine gun nest. I'm just appalling. Okay, anyway, the bridge collapse. We got Donald Trump stuff. We got 50 Cent is involved with this whole business with P. Diddy and a little thing.
Did
and
you
P.
Say, Diddy could how, be. How did you say 50 Cent?
50 Cent. I'm trying to get the. I'm keeping it crunk. Yeah, okay. I'm keeping it crunk, you know.
I'm giving the morning show ammunition for you. So.
What it is. By the way, now they're trying to slow down everything I do to that drunken style of the thing, which is pretty funny. They had me singing Atlantic Station. Anyway, let's get to the phones. Here's Helen. Thank you for holding, Helen. Hello, happy Tuesday, and you're on the radio. What's going on?
Hi, I'm sorry, I'm not Mike.
no, it's
when
okay.
You were talking about stupid quotes about the Key Bridge, did you hear Buttigieg?
I heard part of it. Yeah,
it's a cathedral of American infrastructure, and some of us weren't born when it was built. Well, the damn thing was built in 1977.
No,
it's not even 50 years old. You know, some of us weren't born when my 2020 van came off the line at the automobile factory.
Hell, you could be transportation secretary, Helen.
Oh, I'd have to have a lobotomy first. Gee, I don't know.
Can you believe these people? I mean, it's just outrageous. It's really no longer funny. This administration is just filled with incompetent idiots who are more concerned with how words sound and the definition that they can change to make things better for their outcome of the future of our culture instead of what's actually going on in the world. They're bragging about how great the economy is because gas went from $4.60 for high test to down to $4.30. I mean, it's just unbelievable.
Oh, good. They're only putting bamboos under 7 of our fingernails.
Yeah, so we got 3 to feel good about. Oh,
yeah.
Mercy.
Mercy.
Well, Helen, thanks.
Anyway,
yeah.
And that night the lights went out and Georgia song sucks. Don't trust your soul, you know, backwoods southern lawyer. Because the judge in this town has got bloodstains on his hands. Oh, yeah. Thank you very much.
You know, I actually have never really listened to the words, I think.
Well, no wonder you think it's a nice song.
Well,
it's about a man being.
Yeah. Well, I'm sorry. All right. I'm sorry. I've changed my mind entirely. I say we kill the bitch. What do you think? Let's drive out there right now and we'll strangle her with our bare freaking hands. How about that?
Just kidding.
Yeah, it's getting a little creepy. Thank you, Helen. See ya. I just cut off my own mic.
I saw that.
I don't know what I'm doing over here. I don't know. Do you guys always listen to the words? You don't listen to the words of songs because half the time you don't understand the words.
Yes, we listen to the words.
My ass. You don't half the songs you listen to, you have no idea what they're saying.
No. Bob Dylan taught us that. The Beatles, everybody has great lyrics. The Stones have great lyrics.
Well, I'm a former writer, and I used to be actually creative many years ago. And, you know.
Yeah, you used to write things like Olympic things,
Olympic stories. And, all right.
Johnny Midnight.
Yeah,
you used to do all kinds of interesting stuff.
Well, I used to do stuff.
Yeah.
All right.
Up at 4 a.m. doing what?
All right. Well, I'll do some more then. 508, Kimber, Pete, and Flounder. Oh, mercy. Donald Trump's under another gag order, and his net worth is now about $6.5 billion. Democrats are going nuts.
Yeah, because before he ran for president, he was worth $7 billion.
Yeah, and by the way, he lost most of that running for president. He's the only, he's proving once again, he really was not in it for the money, if anything else. And again, his ego is such, Donald Trump wants to be the best president this country's ever had, which to me is great. I'm fine with that. What other better cause could there be? A higher tribute. Anyway. So he's got all that thing going for us. And the Dem and the liberal leaders are making all this possible. They're just going nuts, rubbing it in his face when he gets $6.5 billion. The little people showing support, even if you buy one or two pieces of stock. What a piece of stock. What the hell? Buy one or two shares of stock. Pieces of stock. Yeah. Hi, Dean Wittery. I'd like to buy seven pieces of stock, please. Anyway, so he's got it made. And by the way, one of his compatriots, another attorney, is facing a big deal problem today. Justice Department official Jeffrey Clark begins a trial today in Washington. He is charged with trying to persuade Georgia officials to overturn Democrat Joe Biden's victory on false pretenses. Dozens of lawyers filing ethics complaints for their roles in the thing. This again, they tried to represent Donald Trump's going to the every possible end they could to say we want to make sure this vote was real, and if it isn't, we want to make sure we get some other electors in there. And because they went to the wall for their client, they're being charged with conspiracy and RICO charges. And this is another one. Oh, by the way, Flounder, the morning show played. I got to get their phone number so I can call them and find out what the hell they got doing here. They played the soundbite of a guy named, and I can't find the damn name now.
Eli Crane,
and is he a congressman? He's somebody involved with the whole Trump business, and he was trying to explain to people why there was no insurrection, which was the first thing I said when they started calling this an insurrection. I remember saying, gee, where are all the guns? Where are all the dead bodies? The only person killed was an innocent, unarmed woman protester killed by a rogue cop. Anyway, here's this fellow talking about
he's an American politician, businessman elected to the U.S. Representatives from Arizona.
Arizona second. Congressman. Okay. And here's what he says about this so-called insurrection business from the beginning.
You know what I love about this? Watching where President Trump is at in the polls. I love it because it shows the American people don't trust you guys. And they shouldn't, because you guys are full of it and everybody knows
talking
it.
To me.
There's a few honest journalists in this town, but they're very few and far between. You know how I know it wasn't an insurrection? Because he hasn't been charged with insurrection. And we can all see by the lawfare how he's facing up over 700 years in jail right now, how they've tried to destroy this man, destroy his businesses, that if they felt they had an inkling of a chance of convicting President Trump of jaywalking or insurrection, they would absolutely charge him. You know how else I know it's not an insurrection? Because this is the first insurrection in the history of the world where the people that were a part of it were unarmed. Pretty hard to do if you walk around and see how many individuals are carrying firearms. All right. Last thing I want to say about how I know it's not an insurrection is because I actually listened to the words of the president. If you're trying to stoke an insurrection, you don't tell the people listening, hey, I want you to go over there peacefully and patriotically. All right. This is not an insurrection. What it is a party that's scared to death of this man because he's America first. And he's shown time and time again he's willing to bust up the swamp, and he continues to beat you like a drum. That's what this is really about.
Fighting the Uniparty. That's an Arizona congressman. What's his name again? Chandler? I forgot.
Eli Crane.
Crane. I like that. I don't know anything about him, but I sure like him.
Like his jib.
Well, there you are. But I mean, I think about it. It was not an insurrection. The only reason they said it was an insurrection because the word insurrection is in the Constitution. That's the only reason they used that word. It was not an insurrection. Only one person died, an innocent woman protester. If that had been a liberal shot by a Republican cop, guess what? That cop would have been in jail like the George Floyd cops for 26 years.
And that cop was never investigated for that shot.
He was not only investigated, he was praised. Nancy Pelosi and all of them gave him an award. They gave him a Heroes Award for saving our democracy from the Donald Trump conspirators to ruin everything. He's a killer.
He's a murderer.
He's a rogue, reckless murderer. He should have been arrested for second-degree manslaughter. God, it's unbelievable. Anyway, 4:13. Luckily, sports is coming up with Pete Davis next. Skipper Pete and Flounder right here. Look out. Oh, my God, already?
What?
Find out something. Will you find something quick? The legend Neil Bortz is only on Extra 106.3. Hey, it's the camera. How's it going? Here's what you missed from the Talkmaster.
Something that I'm enjoying wholeheartedly, the death of DEI. Diversity, equity, and inclusion, all concepts that ignore individuality and celebrate group identities. How long ago did I first start warning you about the word equity? It doesn't mean what you think it means. In its purest sense, it means everybody ought to have the same amount of stuff.
Catch Neil's commentary every day on Extra 106.3 or listen anytime on the Extra 106.3 app.
Convenience is defined as the state of being able to proceed with something with little effort or difficulty. Well, at RBM of Atlanta, we embody this philosophy. Meet our Mercedes-Benz pickup and delivery service. It gives you back time and money. Does your Mercedes-Benz need service? If so, we'll pick up your vehicle that's requiring service from your home or office and bring it back to our dealership for the required service. With over 100 appointments available every weekday, over 50 appointments on Saturdays, and more than 200 courtesy vehicles in our fleet, we're here to serve. We'll work around your schedule. We're here to save you time, energy, and money. RBM of Atlanta is a J.D. Power 2023 Diamond Dealer of Excellence for the customer sales experience and Georgia's only 9-time Mercedes-Benz Best of the Best winner. We're proud to be Atlanta's Mercedes-Benz connection since 1964. Pickup and delivery service restrictions do apply. Ask your service coordinator or service advisor for details.
Is the tax deadline causing you anxiety? Searching for elusive 1099s and trying to uncover any exemptions? If so, you're not alone. Every year, Georgians find themselves looking backwards to file with the IRS, reporting tax history. But what if you were to flip the script? Not just report your taxes, but actually planning for them. We're Master Plan Retirement Consultants. We're local, with offices in Marietta. We work with folks just like you to create a personalized, tax-efficient strategy designed to last a lifetime, a crucial piece to the holistic retirement plan. Do you have a retirement roadmap? You should. It's never too late. Visit MasterPlanRetire.com. Don't wait any longer. Visit MasterPlanRetire.com.
Advisory services offered through Master Plan Retirement Consultants, Inc., a registered investment advisory in the state of Georgia. Insurance, tax, and commodity services offered through Frickson Associates, Inc., DBA Master Plan Retirement Consultants. The aforementioned are affiliated companies.
Neil Bortz here. Maybe you've already taken the steps to improve your health, maybe save your life. You're using a CPAP for your sleep apnea. I've been using one for well over 20 years. So right now, I'm here to tell you about a source for CPAPs and CPAP supplies here in the Atlanta area. CPAPs, etc. They're in Alpharetta. They have whatever you need. Roddy and Sharon are your CPAP experts, and they'll ship nationwide. More information, CPAPs, ETC.com.
Five stars all rise for To Kill a Mockingbird. Unmissable and unforgettable. A mockingbird for our moment. Beautiful, elegiac, satisfying, even exhilarating. A New York Times critic's pick. Mockingbird is now the most successful American play in Broadway history. All rise for Aaron Sorkin's great play. Richard Thomas is Atticus Finch in Harper Lee's To Kill a Mockingbird.
Playing at the Fox Theater May 7th through the 12th. For tickets, visit BroadwayInAtlanta.com.
Hey Atlanta, it's Ben, host of the Weekend Ben Burnett Show, proudly brought to you by Peach State Pride. Each and every weekend, we bring you all the issues going on around the globe and what America's ultimate role is in order to drive our agenda forward as conservatives. And if you ever miss an episode, you can download everything I've ever done on Apple, Spotify, or you can go to the podcast park. See you around, Atlanta.
Introducing Sonder Health Plans, your trusted local partner for Medicare Advantage in Georgia. Only in Georgia. With Sonder, you'll get comprehensive coverage that's tailored to your needs. They offer $0 primary care visits, $0 premiums, and access to a wide network of Georgia healthcare providers. Visit SonderHealthPlans.com now to learn more about their value-based care that won't break the bank. Or call 888-428-4440. Sonder Health Plans, your doctors, your neighbors, your friends.
Lee Brand Jewelry and Watch Company, where quality and value make the difference. Locally owned and located in Sandy Springs, offering you the finest selection of unique diamonds, sapphires, rubies, and emerald jewelry, as well as other fine gemstones. Lee Brand Jewelry and Watches has been servicing Rolex watches for over 30 years, and their Rolex-trained watchmaker will service your watch in their state-of-the-art Rolex service center in their store. Lee Brandt uses only genuine Rolex parts, and their estimates are free. Drop by Lee Brandt in the Trader Joe's Shopping Center in Sandy Springs or visit LeeBrandt.com.
Look out. 519, our 5 o'clock hour, sponsored by Lee Brandt Jewelers. Luxury jewelry and watches are affordable. Drop by their store in Sandy Springs or visit LeeBrandt.com. Look out, it's Kimmer, Pete, and Flounder in Fun Time. Holy crap, it's sports with Pete Davis.
Braves lose to the Twins 9-6 today, but Jared Kelnick smashed his first homer of the spring, a 452-foot monster.
Whoa.
Good for him.
Yeah.
Yeah, Sean Murphy, Orlando Arcia, two RBIs apiece. Orlando a home run. Michael Harris also drove in a run. A.J. Minter roughed up a bit, going two-thirds of an inning, gave up two hits, two earned runs, a walk, a strikeout, and a homer. But Charlie Morton, three scoreless innings, one hit, one walk, and four strikeouts.
So wow.
Charlie
looks good to go. What is he, 40? I mean, my God.
I think he's 40.
Yeah.
I think he's right there.
Good for him.
Dodgers superstar and Pete Rose wannabe Shohei Ohtani read a statement to the media yesterday afternoon, but did not take any questions. Now, Shohei says he's aghast to discover what was happening.
I'm shocked to find that gambling is going on in here.
You're winning, sir.
Oh, thank you very much. Yeah. Everybody out at once.
Yeah.
Somebody is lying. Ohtani's statement 180 degrees in opposition to what they themselves said just last week. During a statement yesterday, Ohtani says he did not learn about anything going on until after the Dodgers players meeting Wednesday. Nearly three full days after MLB and Ohtani's own reps and agent knew about it and were in touch with ESPN. If we believe Shohei, that means that not only his translator, but his agent, spokesperson, the FBI, the Dodgers, MLB, ESPN, and all other media outlets that knew about it, his business manager, and the bank, none of them told the player himself what was going on.
For 3 days.
For 3 days.
Just can't be right. I mean, why would he say
somebody's lying. Obviously, somebody's lying.
Good Lord.
Not good news for MLB, and neither is this. The New York Post reporting ESPN may opt out of its baseball package at the end of this upcoming season.
Whoa. Okay.
Yeah, money.
Money.
It's all about the moolah.
I'll bet.
And for the second straight year, the Mets, the lowly Mets, have the highest payroll, $302 million American dollars, which gets them a next-to-last place team.
Well, this year they're going to go all the way like every other year. The Mets, boy, they watch out for those Mets this year.
Yeah, and they still owe Bobby Bonilla $1.2 million a year.
Every year.
Still. Yankees are second at $290 million. The Phillies are fourth at $236. The Braves are fifth at $224. And guess who's last?
Tampa Bay?
Close. The A's. The poor Oakland A's.
Well, I should have said Oakland, yeah. Right? Yeah.
$47 million payroll.
And ours is $220 million, and theirs is 40-something?
The Mets is 300 plus, and theirs is 47. Only an idiot like Rob Manfred could run an organization with that much discrepancy amongst his franchises.
You can't do anything with that. You can't get
players. NFL shows you exactly what you need to do, and everybody just seems to act like, we have a better plan. Well, and there's never been a better league and more efficient, more money-making league.
But it's not going to make any difference if they move, go somewhere else. They still have to have people willing to spend the money.
That's true. All right. Former Falcon Cordarrelle Patterson has signed a 2-year, $6 million deal with the Steelers. So he's reconnecting with Arthur Smith, the man who ignored him here in Atlanta for the last 3 years. Good luck. By the way, Patterson is the greatest kick returner in NFL history. He has 9 kickoff returns for touchdowns. Nobody else has 9.
Really? I have no idea.
Yeah. I thought there was more. But no, they're claiming he's number one.
That's incredible.
So, I don't want to say the NFL is becoming more effeminate.
No.
But the Bears are thinking of drafting Caitlin Clark with the number one pick with the new rules that they just initiated.
Yeah, don't touch him.
NFL owners approved a massive revamp of the kickoff today. They opted for a format originating in the XFL. Always good to take things from the XFL because that's been a
so
winner all around.
Yeah.
The proposal passed by the owners 29-3. I don't know who the three owners who said no. It would be interesting to find out who they were.
I read it this morning. Pittsburgh. And, I can't remember. I saw it. Somebody wrote it down this morning, and I saw it, and I can't remember. I'll find it.
All right. Well, here's what the NFL lawyers have come up with. And, yes, it sounds like something you'd hear in a courtroom. Here's the new rule. The format will move the majority of the kicking and return teams downfield to minimize high-speed collisions. Kickers will continue to kick from the 35-yard line, but the other 10 players on the kickoff team will line up at the receiving team's 40-yard line. At least 9 members of the return team will line up in a setup zone between the 35 and 30-yard lines. Up to 2 returners can line up in a landing zone between the goal line and the 20-yard line. No one other than the kicker and returners can move until the ball hits the ground or hits a player inside the landing zone. Touchbacks will be marked at the 30-yard line, and no fair catches will be allowed. In the event a team wants to attempt an onside kick, it will have to inform officials of its intent and would then be allowed to use the NFL's traditional formation. No surprise onside kicks will be allowed, unless, of course, it's Thursday night, in which all these rules will be enforced backwards.
You know, I'm not sure about that last part, but even how could you not? How could you possibly have to tell them we're going to do an onside kick? I mean, come on. I mean, what the hell are they doing? And by the way, you have to wait till the ball hits the ground before you start running? Jeez, I mean, my God, man.
You know what we're going to have?
God.
If they get through that first line. But if they get through that first line, you're going to have more exciting. They'll be chasing that sucker.
Well, yeah, I'll tell you what. If I were, and I've got the 3 teams, by the way. If I were the in charge of now these new rules, I would get the fastest players I could find. They may be 5'11 and 190, but they'll be running a 4.240, and you just make it a speed game. Just outrun the bastards. If you can't do really tough tackling, you got to try to use your freaking fingers and stuff. Then just get the fastest guy you can find and just make it a race.
Right. If they don't have to really realize they're going to be hit really hard because those guys are only a few yards in front of them,
run like hell.
Past them.
Yeah. Well, that changes that game. By the way, the 3 teams that voted against this new kickoff rule, the Raiders, the 49ers, and the Packers for the 3.
Packers?
Yep.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. If you think all this sounds ridiculous, inefficient, and mediocre, remember, the NFL competition chairman is Rich McKay.
Oh, God.
Even when he's exiled away from screwing up the Falcons, he still finds a way to monkey up things.
Oh, man. What are they doing?
Now, having said that, they had to do something because the kickoff has become about as entertaining and useful as Jimmy Kimmel's opening monologue.
Let it go in the end zone and take it out to the 30 or whatever.
Yeah,
it is.
It's boring. Stupid. So they had to do something. The NFL will also play 2 games on Christmas Day this year, despite it falling on a Wednesday.
Wednesday? Why would they?
Wednesday.
What? Do they have to play on Christmas Day?
They love playing Christmas Day. The NBA hates it, but they love to play on Christmas Day.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Your Atlanta Hawks rallied for one of their greatest regular season wins in franchise history last night in State Farm Arena. I told you you should have gone.
I know. I was going to be there. I know. I couldn't drive a place to park.
Erasing a 30-point deficit, they beat the Red Hot Celtics 120-118. DeAndre Hunter scored 24, including the go-ahead 3-pointer with 9 seconds left, the dagger. Yeah. Boston had won 20 of 22, had brought a 9-game winning streak into the contest, and the Hawks took care of them. It's also the biggest comeback win for Atlanta since at least the 97-98 season when they began taking looking at this pretty closely.
Yeah.
Georgia head coach Kirby Smart addressed the media about the DUI arrest of his running back Trevor Etienne Sunday morning in Athens. Smart says he's disappointed with Etienne's decision making, but he's a good kid. Meanwhile, more disturbing details about the good kid's arrest.
Oh.
It's worse than we first thought. According to 24/7 Sports, Trevor was driving away from downtown Athens. He locked up the brakes of his sedan. An officer saw it, made a U-turn, and observed the vehicle pass another car driving in the same direction across the double yellow line on a blind curve. The officer turned on his lights. He reached speeds of 90 miles an hour, but Etienne's vehicle pulled away from him.
Oh, boy.
He continued to weave in and out of traffic, crossing the double yellow lines, and then he came to a stop, said he'd had a few drinks, but refused to take the field sobriety test, so he was detained.
Yeah, that'll cost him a year with no license. If you refuse to take the test, I think it's an automatic loss of a license for a year.
I don't understand why they all don't have Uber or they have a personal driver or something. The big guys like him, he makes some money now. Come on. Pay somebody to drive you around.
Stupid. Well, I mean, what kind of decision? Well, they're kids. You know, they're 19 or 20 or whatever. But still, I mean, what kind of decision is it to run from the cops?
I think he's underage, too. I think he's like, 19, 20, something like that?
Unbelievable.
No mention of where did you have these drinks?
Who served you?
Anyway. And finally, New York Jets cornerback Sauce Gardner, busy making friends, especially up there in New York City.
Okay, all right.
Saying on a podcast that, quote, Jews run the world.
Oh, God.
End quote. And then he also went on to say about Jews, y'all got to see how they be walking in the airport.
Oh, God. Be walking in the airport? Jew walking? Is that a thing now? Jew walking?
Guess,
oh, my God.
So.
Wait, no, wait a minute.
I've got to look out for it.
And he's in New York saying this.
Yeah. New York City.
Jew walking. I didn't know that was. I was going to ask the rhino. I had no idea there was a thing. Jew walking.
Rhino, if you're listening, please call
Lordy.
Up
we
and
gotta
tell
get
us what Jew walking is.
Bottom of this, all right.
Oh, my God. In New York. It's not like he's in Sacramento somewhere.
What the hell is Jew walking? Holy crap. All right. Well, I mean, we got a couple of birthdays here, Pete Davis. John Stockton, Hall of Famer, former Utah Jazz guard, 62. Marcus Allen, I put a picture of him and me. I met him at Publix a couple of years ago, and I had my, like, a Raiders hat on, and he came up and took a selfie with me, and I put his picture on Facebook. Marcus Allen is 64. Let's see. Hold on. This was the day, yesterday in 1995, Mike Tyson got out of prison, but it was on this day, 92, that he got convicted for raping Desiree Washington. Two years later, he would turn into a cannibal with the father of a former father of Atlanta, Vander Holyfield. And the L.A. Lakers, 72, set a record for the NBA, winning 69 of their 82 games. And Magic Johnson in Michigan State, what a game. One of the greatest NCAA finals of all time. 1979, Magic and Michigan State defeated Larry Bird in Indiana 75-64 in 1979. Anyway, Pete Davis, Cameron Flounder, 531. More coming up here with President Stupid Face, too.
The latest breaking news to the conservative voices you know and trust. Your best new follow on social media is Extra 1063. We're at XTRA 1063 on Twitter, Facebook, TikTok, Threads, and LinkedIn, and pretty much any social media you scroll through every day. And we drop exclusive giveaways, new daily content, and the latest breaking news from Georgia and across this great nation. Interact with your favorite Extra personalities. Get the latest on our live events and so much more. Follow at Extra 1063 across all your social media and keep up with Atlanta's only conservative voice.
Troop Rep on Cobb Parkway is your one-stop shop for emergency preparedness supplies, including freeze-dried food, water filtration, first aid, and more. They also have a large selection of firearms, including a huge selection of AR-15s, firearm accessories, and ammo at the lowest prices around. They are locally owned and operated. You can visit their store in Marietta on Cobb Parkway or online at trueprep.com. That's TRUprep.com. Prepare today for a worry-free tomorrow at Troop Rep.
Hey, homeowners, Tug here with some exciting news. Southern Exteriors is your one-stop solution for top-notch exterior services, from roofing to siding, windows, gutters, and more. No more waiting. They can start on your project immediately. And with an in-house warranty division, Southern Exteriors stands by their work for years to come. From leaky roofs to faded siding, trust Southern Exteriors for a quick and lasting transformation. Don't wait. Transform your home today. Call 877-9-SOUTHERN or visit southernexteriors.co now. Southern Exteriors, quality and precision you can rely on for over 20 years.
Millions of guys suffer from erectile dysfunction. That's one in four men. And I can tell you, I'm one of them.
If you or someone you know suffer from ED, Peyronie's disease, or PE, here's 38-year emergency room doctor and founder of Total Body Therapy of Georgia, Dr. Eric Deal.
Patients who enter my office are often frustrated, hopeless, depressed, and embarrassed. I understand the problem, and I'm going to help you fix it. There are lots of competitors that don't have the credentials that I have. When you go to other clinics, you're not going to see board-certified physicians with the experience that I have. When you come to our clinic, you're going to see me. There's just not one therapy that can solve these complex issues. I'll do a complete history and physical prior to any treatment that we use. Take it from me, Dr. Deal. When it's not hard, it's really hard.
Call Dr. Deal for your free one-on-one evaluation and resolve your ED, Peyronie's, or PE issues. Total Body Therapy of Georgia, 404-777-1911. 404-777-1911. Online at StopMyED.com.
Hey, sandwich lovers. Today's your lucky day. There's a whole new way to roll for lunch or dinner delight with Nucky's Hoagies in the Roswell Corners Shopping Center. Now open. Nucky's Hoagies in Roswell is family owned and operated by the sub-sisters, Stacy and Shannon, whose love language is food and Nucky's Hoagies, their passion. When you bite into a Nucky's Hoagie, you'll taste the difference. The softest hoagie rolls ever, along with hunger-quenching sandwich combinations. Make Nucky's Hoagies in Roswell on Woodstock Road your new favorite spot for lunch or dinner.
It's a mad world out there, but one thing is certain, everyone is trying to market something. So tune in every Saturday at 3 p.m. to the Marketing Mad Men, who, along with a variety of industry expert guests, can help you make sense of it all. Whether you own a business and want tips to scale, or are a fan of the finer things in life and want to know how restaurants, golf courses, and wine companies try to sell you stuff, the Marketing Mad Men is your ultimate destination for all things marketing. Tune in right here on Extra 106.3 every Saturday at 3 p.m. or search online for more content. Join the madness with the Marketing Mad Men.
At the Piedmont Bank, we're proud to be one of Georgia's largest community banks, focusing on serving businesses and the communities they serve. With headquarters right here in Metro Atlanta, our tailored banking expertise and solutions help meet the diverse needs of our customers so they have what it takes to grow, expand, and thrive. It's what elevates us above the rest. Find a location near you at Piedmont.bank and experience elevated banking for you and your business. The Piedmont Bank. Banking elevated. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Hey there, it's Tara, owner and publisher of Our Town Monthly, where you'll find familiar faces, local voices, and community businesses like JRM Management.
Thanks, Tara. I'm Missy Miller, event coordinator at JRM Management. We are your event specialist. We're excited to see you at the Georgia Food and Wine Festival, March 21st through the 24th. We'll have food, beverages, cooking demos, live music, shopping, and more. Or maybe you're looking for an event where you can bring the entire family. Join us at the Marietta Community Egg Hunt Friday, March 29th, and the Northeast Cobb Community Egg Drop Saturday, March 30th. There will be multiple egg hunts by age and lots of kid-friendly activities. Also, look out for the Kennesaw Big Shanty Festival, the Smyrna Spring Donquil Festival, and of course, the North Georgia State Fair. There's always something fun happening in our community, and we want you to know about it. That's why we love our partnership with Our Town Monthly.
You are so right, Missy. If JRM is there, the fun follows. Friends, check out all the exciting community events hosted by JRM Management. And remember, Our Town is your town at Our Town Monthly.
A little Hall of Notes here. I don't know why they did that tinny production like the old days. You know, Mike, Molly, and say your mammy kind of deal. I don't know. It seemed to me they were not giving their voices there a full breath of happiness. Anyway, 1977, Hall & Oates started a three-week run at number one with Rich Girl. It was their first number one in America. Hall & Oates have sold 40 million records, making them the third best-selling music duo of all time. Wow, didn't say who the first two were. Probably, if Hall & Oates are the third best-selling duo, who would the first number one and two duo be?
Well, Jan and Dean. Simon and Garfunkel did all right.
Yeah, Jan and Dean. Simon and Garfunkel probably for sure. Other
the
duos.
Carpenters were a duo?
Yeah,
the
Carpenters. But best-selling of all time? I don't know if Carpenter. Well, I don't know.
They did very well. Captain and Tennille.
Yeah, there's another one. That's good. I'm trying to think of doing
Ike and Tina.
Ike and
Simon
Tina.
And Garfunkel. Simon the Everly Brothers. Sonny and Cher.
There you go. Now we got some.
The Righteous Brothers.
Oh, yeah. Righteous Brothers. There you go. There's a
Cher.
Lot of them. Sonny and Cher.
The White Stripes. Outkast.
Yeah, oh, my. My goodness. Our birthday list includes, speaking of music, Steven Tyler, 76, the Aerosmith frontman. Steven, 76. And Diana Ross of the Supremes is 80. Her daughter is Tracy Ellis Ross, Anthony Anderson's wife on Blackish. For the record, Diana Ross, 80 today, and Steven Tyler, 76. And on this day in history, oh, this is pretty cool. It's kind of a little thing. I looked up some extra stuff on this last night, or I guess it was actually this morning. Actually, I was up at up a little early this morning around 5 because I wanted to watch the end of that stupid Bachelor. I didn't watch it. I watched part of it last night because I was mad about it, so I kind of boycotted it, but I had to watch the ending of it. And I actually have some very nice things to say about a certain girl, but anyway, we'll get to that in a second. All right, 5:38, Kim, Repeat, and Flounder. On this day, in 1953, the March of Dimes worked. And here's the rest of the story. Dr. Jonas Salk announced that his vaccine works. He tested it on 90 children and adults. 2 years later, it was given to every child in the United States. After World War II, polio spread like crazy. My friend Tim Dorman's father was a doctor, and we thought, oh my God, how could a doctor's son get polio? Because we didn't know what it was. And we were, as kids, we were told, again, after World War II, polio spread, all of a sudden, like, there were 30,000 cases of children in America just like overnight. And our parents would tell, in the summertime, we were told to come in the afternoon. We were not allowed to play in the afternoon in the summer heat. We had to come in and take a nap because they thought that we would get tired and overtired would cause the disease of polio. And that's what, you know, this, again, he was 8 years old or 10 years old or something in the 50s. And so I was saying, but now here's the rest of the story. The response to the national program, he went on the radio in 1953 and said, everything's fine. This is a great vaccine. It's going to be good. He was the embodiment of a vaccine that would soon save the world from polio, according to one expert. To the public, he was an immediate hero. But members of the scientific community criticized Jonas Salk for talking about unpublished data for pandering to the media. Again, this is 1953. The radio address marked the beginning of an animosity that Salk would suffer for the rest of his life. Salk's fellow scientists were seething with resentment and professional jealousy. Quote, whether he believes it or not, Jonas went on the air that night to take a bow and become a public hero, and that's what he became, observed one critic. His rival in polio vaccine research, Albert Sabin, you remember to know that name, was particularly venomous. It was pure kitchen chemistry, Sabin said later. Salk didn't discover anything. Jonas Salk's reputation among his peers as an inconsequential, I can't read my damn writing here, showboat was such a little of his subsequent research was ever taken seriously. Jonas Salk's reputation was so bad, no one took him seriously. He never won a Nobel Prize. He was never welcomed into the prestigious National Academy of Sciences. The snubs rankled, but several years before his death in 1995, Jonas Salk seemed philosophical. Quote, I received an inordinate amount of attention and recognition out of proportion to what was contributed scientifically. It came about together because of the relief from fear. It was a human response on the part of the public, but from the point of view of the scientific community, they would see it differently. That was an adverse side effect, but it also provided opportunities in other ways. Those are the prices one has to pay for the pluses as well as the minuses. Jonas Salk.
How different, because back then the scientists spoke out and said, look, this isn't right, blah, blah, blah. Today, the last few years, they leveled this Fauci That's guy right. up on a pedestal
yeah.
and refute, and everything he said was the gospel, and everybody was afraid to utter one word against
yeah.
him.
Yeah. And again, these were scientists said, now, wait a minute. We need to see more published proof on this. We just can't go off talking about stuff like this and making it a thing. Again, that was 1953. 70 years and one. I mean, wow. Anyway, how you doing? 542, can repeat and flounder. Oh, by the way, we've been talking about that bridge thing. I still don't know. Has anyone heard how long the captain had between when he knew he couldn't steer the ship to the time it hit? How is it possible that anybody was still on that bridge? They had 6 or 8 workers up there filling potholes. They were there. There was nothing wrong with the bridge. It was fine. They were filling potholes at 1:30 in the morning, so they wouldn't be involved with rush hour. How were they still on the bridge when the captain knew the steering ship was going to hit the bridge? Why didn't they stop everything? How did anybody remain on the bridge? Unless it was like 20 seconds, and I don't think that was the case, but I don't know. I mean,
imagine a worker. You've been there for 2 weeks every night, putting those potholes, yeah. filling them up.
Yeah, Tarvia,
and then
yeah.
one ship.
And you see it coming at you. And that's the other thing. I mean, they must have seen the damn thing coming.
Oh, yeah. You could see it for
and it's
half
not,
a mile.
It's not going 50 miles an hour. It's going probably 2. I don't understand. I mean, it's a horrible, horrible thing. But
you're on the bridge waving your arms.
Wait, we're over here. By the way, a story just popped up on my computer here about. Well, now it's disappeared. You little bastards, where are you? They must have buried it again. Here we go. Our former quarterback, former NFL. What's the matter?
Oh, I'm just answering the phone with the mic on. Bingo card.
Bingo.
Former NFL star Vince Young was in a bar fight recently and got sucker punched and knocked out. He was at an incident, a scrum involved around a circular bar. One man said, Houston. It was in Houston, and it was at a bar. People started shoving around. It was a circular bar. One guy seen throwing punches at somebody else trying to walk out of the bar, and then the same guy turned around and clocked Vince Young with a right hook, and it was a sucker punch. Vince Young didn't know it was coming and knocked him out cold. Apparently, they caught the guy, and there was a drink thrown during the altercation. The owner said it was the guy and elbowed in the head, and apparently no charges pressed because they were having a bar fight.
Well,
but Vince Young got knocked out cold.
Obviously, Vince needs to sign up to Cam Newton's course of haberdashery and hand fight.
Yeah, and keep your hat on at the same time, apparently. Holy smokes. And by the way, NBC News executives apparently been meeting today to find out what they're going to do with Ronna McDaniel. I think this is such a scandal. This is such a disgrace. And again, the deterioration of the First Amendment. I tell you, people my age are absolutely apoplectic about what's happened to freedom of speech, freedom of the press, and the media in the last 50 years, let alone the last 4, 6, or 8 years. Unbelievable. Ronna McDaniel, basically harmless, to be part of a discussion group for NBC to give a point of view from another side, and the other people at MSNBC are so livid. Rachel Maddow, and by the way, Ronna McDaniel was being paid $300,000 a year. Rachel Maddow, I think it's $25 million.
30, and her show's once a week.
Once a week, yeah. $30 million once a week. And they paid Ronna McDaniel $30,000.
One looks like a guy.
Anyway.
40 viewers.
Yeah. 6:15. We got Flounder's Funny coming up and newsy stuff, including the social media thing, and kind of a funny cartoon about it, too. Coming up, Kimmer, Pete, and Flounder. Don't go away now.
Hey, it's Rhino from The Morning Extra, getting your weekday morning started from 6 to 10 a.m.
They're like setting their own traps.
That's exactly right, Rhino. That's right.
Yeah. They're like Wile E. Coyote. They're like putting a stick, and they're looking, where's the roadrunner?
Exactly.
And then he goes, did he just come through? And then it falls on them.
Our stinking president is dumber than Wile E. Coyote. Joe Biden is Elmer Fudd.
He looks in the end of the gun to see why he didn't fire.
Boom! And then
his face is all black.
Donald Duck, you know, where it knocks his bill around backwards and he can't tell where he is. That's what Joe Biden is.
Yeah.
He's
also, hold on, time out. He's also Pepe Le Pew. He sniffs a girl and then just floats in the air towards her.
Joe Biden is a Looney Tunes character, y'all. He's every one of them in one. This is amazing. It could not get better.
The Morning Extra, 6 to 10 a.m. on Extra 106.3 FM and the Extra app.
Buying a new car is about way more than just a car. You want to love it and everything that comes with it. And at Subaru of Gwinnett, we get that. You want to love the website. Easy to browse, easy to shop, and an unrivaled selection so you can find the model that suits you. Like the 2024 Subaru Outback, Crosstrek, or Ascent, all offering impressive gas mileage, standard symmetrical all-wheel drive, and the tools to explore the things you love. You want to love the people, and know that every time you stop by the dealership on Satellite Boulevard in Duluth, they'll be there for you, ready to help in any way possible. And you want to love the service. We'll check that box for you also, because during the spring sales event, there's a lot to love. So stop in during the Subaru A Lot to Love event, and you'll find just that. A lot to love. Start your shopping online at SubaruofGwinnett.com and find the ride that best suits you. Because love is what makes a Subaru. Subaru of Gwinnett, Satellite Boulevard in Duluth, and online at SubaruofGwinnett.com.
Hey there, it's Janelle King, host of the Janelle King Show, right here on Extra 106.3 FM, where we are unafraid and unapologetic. We explore the topics that matter the most. You can catch us on Saturdays at 4 p.m. and encore episode on Sundays at 9 a.m. And catch up on past episodes by going to the podcast park right here at Extra 106.3 or wherever you get your podcasts every single Tuesday. Until then, stay unafraid, stay unapologetic, and never stop seeking the truth.
Is this the year you want to grow your business? Do you want to expand your team?
build a new office? Hey, it's Tug, and I want to tell you about First Liberty Building and Loan. Aren't you exhausted by going to lenders, building a relationship, and a week later, you're dealing with a new person? You won't have to with First Liberty Building and Loan. The Frost family has been helping businesses grow since the 90s, and they can help you too. They know the patterns, they know the ebbs and flows, and they know business. Now the Frost family wants to know you. FirstLibertyGA.com. Buying a building, building a building, buying a franchise, or expanding. Reach out and spend 10 minutes with them. See if you're a fit for them and if they're a fit for you. FirstLibertyGA.com. By the way, if you're a young banker and you want to work with a team that's faith-friendly with a culture of excellence, First Liberty might be a good match. Reach out to First Liberty Building and Loan at FirstLibertyGA.com. That's FirstLibertyGA.com.
Hey, it's Front Office Lowe's for Underdog Fantasy. The NBA season is still here, and there's no easier way to get in on all the action than with Underdog Fantasy and their Pick'em game. It's a fantasy game, but you can win real money. It's easy. Pick 2 to 5 players from at least 2 different teams. Select higher or lower on the player stats, and if your pick hits, you can win up to 100 times your money. It's legal in Georgia, and it's a ton of fun to play as you can watch the Atlanta Hawks. Stop playing against the pros night in and night out with their hundreds of different lineups. It's just you against the stat. It's that easy. Underdog Fantasy is even easier to get started. Go to their easy-to-use mobile app or to underdogfantasy.com. Sign up and use the promo code LOS, and Underdog will match your first deposit up to $100. Plus, they'll give you a mystery special pick to use on your first pick of entry. That's Underdog Fantasy, promo code LOS, L-O-S, to get your first deposit of 10 or more matched plus your special pick. Must be 18 and present in state where Underdog Fantasy operates. Terms apply. Concerned with your play? Call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit ncpgambling.org.
No one plans on going to jail, but when it happens, it's important that you know who to call. Call A Second Chance Bail Bonds, where we believe everyone deserves a second chance. We handle bonds throughout Metro Atlanta, including from our newest offices in Cherokee County and Clayton County. In most cases, we can have you or your loved one out of jail in a matter of hours. A Second Chance. It's better to know us and not need us than need us and not know us. Call A Second Chance 24/7 at 404-BAIL-OUT or online at atlbail.com.
Lee Brand Jewelry and Watch Company, where quality and value make the difference. Locally owned and located in Sandy Springs, offering you the finest selection of unique diamonds, sapphires, rubies, and emerald jewelry, as well as other fine gemstones. Lee Brand Jewelry and Watches has been servicing Rolex watches for over 30 years, and their Rolex-trained watchmaker will service your watch in their state-of-the-art Rolex service center in their store. Lee Brand uses only genuine Rolex parts, and their estimates are free. Drop by Lee Brand in the Trader Joe's Shopping Center in Sandy Springs or visit LeeBrand.com.
I don't get this freaking line. Does your crap pad, what do they call it? I suck. What are the crap pad thing? Is yours like this? It's just unbelievable. I'm scrolling up and down, nothing. It's just stuck there. And then like 8 seconds later, it'll go zoink. Now I went to the homepage. Oh, that's what I wanted. All right, let me go ahead and push the Fox News app 95 times. I don't get it. I mean, are they all like this?
Well, it's not that. It freezes on the Fox app every time you use it. So it's obviously the ads from the Fox app.
God, it's crap.
Anyway, 5:52.
I thought these are things were supposed to make our lives easier. And now it's spazzing out. Now I can't even get back to the homepage.
I don't care. Screw it. I'm not going to use it. Okay, 5:52. How you doing?
It's going to make your.
We need to have a live. We should just have a live feed that would seize your face.
I'm hitting the thing right now.
It was like watching a Charlie Chaplin silent movie. I was just sitting here watching him go nuts.
God, I can't believe it.
Kimber, it's not supposed to make your life easier. It's supposed to make your life shorter.
Ah, thank God. Well, I'm way overdue. Take me now.
How funny would that be if God just went bang, lightning right in my eye.
I would right. Not be
zoink,
doing that.
And you'd be like, oh my God, I got him. I dare you. I dare you.
Crime. I'm sorry, I played a little Marvin Gaye here, Flounder. I've ruined your whole musical there. Our musical director, Flounder, I've ruined his entire effort here. Well, heard it through the grapevine, baby. 1969, Marvin Gaye, number one. Heard it through the grapevine, number one in Britain, yeah. It was first recorded by the Miracles and had been a million seller in 1967 for Gladys Knight and the Pips. And in 67 and then 69, Marvin Gaye, number one with a two. So good for you. And let's see, birthdays, got a few birthdays. Kenny Chesney, 56 years old today. Let's see, my granddaughter Molly, I mentioned several times, is 10 years old, hit double digits. Love that little girl. She's just a treasure. Lisa Gibbons, remember her? The former TV girl, 67 years old. She did one of those Hollywood things with, what's her name, with the legs? Mary Hart, or whatever her name was.
Entertainment Tonight.
Entertainment Tonight thing, yeah. Lisa Gibbons, 67. Martin Short, 74 years old today. And it says here his claim to fame on this listing is only Murders in the Building. What the hell is that?
It's a. He does it with the Selena and Steve Martin. It's been a big hit on Hulu, I think.
I'll be darned. Martin Short, 74. Bob Woodward, one of the reporters who took down Nixon, 81. Nancy Disgusto Pelosi is going to go to hell when she dies. The black-hearted, lying, skank traitor, 84. And Curtis Sliwa, the former guardian angel and talk show host currently, is 70 years old today. And on this day in history, 1964, Malcolm X and Martin Luther King Jr. met for the first and last time in Washington, D.C. in 1964, debating the Civil Rights Act of 1964. 5:55. Flounder, before we forget, let's get President Pukeface Murderer. Once again, here's his comments. He, by the way, after the bridge collapse, we have a phone call, don't we? I almost blew it again.
Who yeah, do
we
Martin.
Have? Martin, you're on the radio. Real, I'm sorry to make you wait, Martin. You're on the air. What's going on? What do you think? yes, sir.
The issue with the boat, number one, yeah, it was out there a long time coasting towards the pillar, okay?
Yeah.
And actually, it wasn't the pilot's the one that's steering the boat at that point in time. Okay,
right.
He's the one that steered it into the pillar. Okay,
mm-hmm.
And you can go into the dynamics of the prop, the direction it spins, and then when it's not, or when it's freewheeling, it's sort of causing a backwards motion, causing the aft end of the boat to go a different direction. But anyhow, the point is, they should have had tugs if they didn't, and the pilot should never be behind the helm of a boat again. The cost of lives, you know, there's the, fortunately, it's less than 10 people, as I understand it, that lost
apparently,
their lives.
Apparently, yeah.
But the cost of the bridge, the cost to all of the people that relied on that bridge, now they're commuting, adding, you know, hours and hours and hours.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, fortunate for you and I, we're going to have a Congress. They'll have a subcommittee.
Yeah.
They'll do all the grandstanding.
It's
they'll be talking about it. And Buttigieg, he's probably at home nursing his child.
Yeah.
And I do mean literally.
Trying to breastfeed.
And,
yeah, I'm sure of it.
Yeah. And, you know, nothing's, it's just, you know, the United States is like that bridge.
I know.
You know, we're collapsing.
We're broken. We are broken.
Aren't
people seeing it? I mean, it's almost unbelievable. I mean, it's right in front of our eyes. Thank you. I really appreciate your being part of this. Again, we're all flabbergasted. Before we go, President Pukeface. We have President Pukeface. We have time for him real quick. He actually talked about going over that bridge on a train.
At about 1:30, container ship struck the Francis Scott Key Bridge, which I've been over many, many times commuting from the state of Delaware in our train or by car.
Yeah, by train or by car. There's no train. There are no train tracks on that bridge. President Pukeface just made it up again. He told another story. Surprised he didn't say they, you know, there was a fire there and he almost lost his son in Iraq at the same time the train ran over him. Dear God. Let's take a breath. Everything's going to be fine. We'll have election coming up and maybe this will all be done. Boy, is there a lot to undo. Is there a lot to undo? Anyway, Flounder, how about a little Flounder's Funny before we go? One last shot. What do you think?
I had a fight recently at 3 a.m. We woke up to get in this fight. We have a dog, and our dog, freaks out when it thunders. And so we have sedatives to give her because there's only so many times you can tell a dog it's just thunder before you're like, she's not getting it, you know. And you're like, just take this, all right? So I woke up. I had to wake my wife up, and I was like, hey, where are the sedatives at? And she was like, they're at the top of the cabinet. So I go get them. I looked at the bottle, and the bottle said they were expired. So I had to wake my wife back up, and I was like, hey, these say they're expired. And she was like annoyed. She was like, they're not expired, all right? They're new pills in an old pill bottle. And I was like, all right, I should have thought of that. You know, that's my I mean, we have people come to our house all the time and they get milk and they're like, is this milk expired? And I have to go, that's new milk in an old milk jug. Are you the stupidest person I've ever met? Why would you not assume that's what it is? That's roughly what I told her. It wasn't as fun as that. But and then she goes all in and tells me it doesn't matter because dog medicine can't even expire, which I was like, you've never even heard a rumor about that. You don't know that. We don't know any dog medicine people. I know who she knows. We don't know one dog medicine maker that's texting her like, hey, we're doing some pretty big things at the dog medicine factory. I wanted to let you know first, but we've invented medicine that can't expire. So feel free to tell your husband at 3 a.m.
Yeah, especially wake him up at 3 in the morning to argue about
it. Yeah, I should have thought of that.
Nate Bargatze, is that our boy there?
That was Mr. Nate Bargatze.
I love it. All right, boys, it's almost 6 o'clock. It's on the Kimmer with Pete Davis and Flounder. I gotta go. You're killing me. Well, it's hump day tomorrow. Open herp, look out, herp. Hang in there, look out.
The Kimmer Show is back every afternoon from 3 to 6 p.m. Only on WFOM Marietta, a Dickey broadcasting station. Extra 106.3 FM.